Hey guys, I'm just saying hi to my people that are coming in to watch my blog. Hey everybody. Today, I'm meeting up with my friend Eric, who is dating my friend Elaine. And I'm excited about that. I used to work with Eric for many years, and he was a very, very good friend of mine. And he moved away. Oh, bad filter. Okay, hold on one second. I'm just gonna change a couple things right now, so just get a snack. Oh, thank you, Caleb. Thank you so much, sweetheart. Caleb is like so nice to me, and I really appreciate anyone that is as nice as Caleb, because he's so nice and supportive. So thank you for that, Caleb. Hey, Penny. Okay, so what's happening? Oh, thank you, Summer Page. Thanks, guys. You guys are so nice. So what's happening right now is I haven't gone live in a very long time, okay? I haven't gone live in a long time because I haven't really had many people to go live with. I'm hiring an assistant for my IRL streams, and that assistant is named Judy, and I'm meeting up with her tomorrow after I go to a coin convention with Moss. So tomorrow I'm going to Long Beach, California, to the coin and sports memorabilia collection convention. And I will be with Moss there. And then I'm meeting up with my friend Judy, who is an old colleague of mine and Eric's. And I'm gonna hire her as my assistant. Am I too orange? It's just the filter. Yeah, Weezy, I'm meeting up with Moss. Some people like him, some people don't. But then I'm also meeting up with my friend Judy, who I'm paying. I'll just be honest. So I'm paying her like minimum wage, like $16 an hour to hold my speaker, be there with me, help me get to events, drive me around. And I think that's okay, right? What do you think? I don't know. Is that a good job for someone? So yeah, $16 an hour to carry around my speaker and basically just be there with me and enjoy whatever event we decide to go to. So Judy will be starting this weekend, but I'm meeting up with her tomorrow to go over things, and she's also giving me a dog. So there's a couple good things gonna be happening. I don't swallow, no. Hell no. Yeah, so I'm hiring. Elisa's hiring right now. The reason why I'm hiring is because I need help. It's very hard to do this by myself. Oh, hey, Blackout Andy. So I'm hiring people anywhere from minimum wage, which is like $16 an hour, I think, to, okay, I'm not on IP2 for some reason, again. Huh. IP2. Helps. I'm hiring people to help me with my IRL because it's impossible to do it by oneself. I was going to actually put an ad on Craigslist for an assistant, but I figured I would just go to my friend Judy, who was looking for a job, and a couple other of my friends that were looking for jobs, because I could just pay them and they already know like the situation. So I thought that was good to do. So we're about to meet my friend Eric, and I'm excited about that. I know, I'm low on the list. It's okay, you guys. It's okay. We're gonna do some IRL. We're gonna do some singing and dancing. We're gonna have some fun today with my friend Eric. Thanks, Weezy. No, Luke. I'm only hiring people that like me. I'm not gonna hire anybody that doesn't like me. My streams used to be good. We'll see if this one today is good. I think it will be good. So my relationship with Eric, I knew him for years. He worked at my company, my old company, and he proposed to me in the office. That was nice because not that many people proposed to me. In fact, only one other. Change my filter. Only one other person proposed to me besides Eric. Thank you, J Prime. Thank you. You guys are very nice. Let me just make sure Power Chat's working. Thank you for our super stickers. You guys are so nice. Let me just make sure Power Chat's working right now. Oh, it is.
Summer Page 9 sent $5.
Thank you. Thank you, Summer Page.
Something was wrong. Brother, have you lost your mind? Well, we used to be friends. Now it's gotta end. It's nothing that you did or said. You got something scary. A little round hairy doorknob on the back of your head. You got a man bun. Drop the knot, son. It don't look right on the mail. You got a man bun. Like a pin. Cushion held together with a rubber band. You ain't a ballerina.
Max, you're talking
you
weird.
Ain't a samurai.
Sorry.
You don't work at the library. Nip it in the bud, stud. You ain't hanging out with me.
Thank you, Summer. So it's kind of like a weird situation right now because Eric asked me to marry him and now he's dating my friend Elaine. Elaine doesn't want to be involved in today, but Eric does. So let's see, you know, when we meet up with Eric, how he feels about everything. It's a really confusing and weird situation, obviously. But I'm excited to see Eric and I hope Elaine changes her mind. I hope she changes her mind because we used to have so much fun together and we just had the best time ever. And we just had so many laughs. Like, I'm sure you guys remember, like, Elaine and me just having the best time. Having the best time. Like, IRL is so fun when you're with, like, the right people. Where is this place? Are we close, sir?
Yes.
We are? Okay, should I get out? I don't know. I don't know if I should get out or not. Eric should be on his way. Wheezy, I'm not sure what's going on exactly, but, you know, I had so much fun, like, with Elaine. We met so many people when we were doing IRL because, like, if you're just, you know, walking down the street, like, people don't really approach you that much. But if you're doing IRL and you're, like, really into it and you're singing or dancing, everybody approaches you. It's, like, the best feeling. It's the best. Like, there's nothing more fun than doing IRL and, like, you know, dancing and singing, having people be like, oh, what's going on there? Like, it's just the best. So the fact that she doesn't want to be a part of it anymore, I'm going to talk to Eric about it and see what he says. Let me see where Eric is. But I mean, worst case scenario, I'll just go to the ATM. am I going to visit Captain Content? That would be tough to do. That would be really tough. But, I mean, that would be fine. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. Elaine doesn't like IP2. She never wanted me on it. And she was really mad that I was on it. She wanted me to get off of it. But she doesn't understand. That's just people. Exactly, Penny. It is sad. Like, Penny, I think if you're Penny from Arizona, like, you want to do IRL, like, people see, like, the joy that comes from IRL. There's a lot of joy there. And you're missing out, I feel, if you don't want to be a part of it. I feel that she is missing out. So I don't want her to miss out on things. I don't want my friends to miss out on things. I'm, like, paying people now And so I just feel like it's a good opportunity for somebody to start something and build. Like, you could build a lot from this. I know it sounds crazy. Like, I just went into, a couple weeks ago, I just went into like this job opportunity because they saw that I had a good social media following. So they invited me into their office to do their social media, and I did an interview about that. So things happen and you get connections from it. And somebody's calling. Kermit and Friends IRL, how can I help you?
Hi, you give me so much information. Are you on live right now?
I'm live right now.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, okay, no wonder. Yeah, I can tell your whole attitude is different with me.
What do you mean?
You know who this is?
Virtuous. Oh, is this it? Is this Trunks? Where?
Do you know who this is?
Right there.
Oh, Hollywood Burger. This is it. Okay, this is it. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. Is this Virtuous Spartan?
What's
up, Virtuous Spartan? How are you?
Hi.
Hi.
You know what? Elisa, we've had a relationship for about three, four months now.
You and I?
Well, not a relationship, but we got acquainted and then it got a little weird, but we're gonna really get into some really deep stuff really soon, right?
Hey, I'm just waiting for my friend, Eric. Is he here?
Oh, you're waiting for the degenerate, that fat piece of shit?
No, he's not fat. He's very thin. He's good looking.
The Stern Show? The other little Eric, the guy that you told me that the effeminate guy.
He's not effeminate.
You told me he was effeminate. Don't worry about him.
I did not say that.
Don't worry about him, Spartan. He's effeminate. I'm not going to do anything with him. I love you. I'm going to fuck you. I'm going to suck your dick.
I don't think I said that.
Right?
All right, you're making me have to leave this restaurant because, like, your language is very bad.
No, because you're a fucking fake sociopath, and everybody knows that you just use it and abuse people when you just fucking try to go underneath all the shady, grimy liberals. You're a fucking little creep. You're a slimy fucking little slug. You're a fucking little fucking narcissistic fucking sociopath fucking punk. And you suck my dick every night. You talked to me 3 hours last night, or 2 days ago, 3 hours. And then the night before, you talked to me another 3 hours. You're a fucking pig. You suck the life out of me. You're obsessed with me. And everybody knows it. And I'm going to bring out everything that you to me, you conveyed. I've already done a lot of this shit. Everybody look at my channel. Virtuous Alex Spartan. New chapter. Look at all my channel. Look at everything I fucking expressed. All the fucking videos. All the shit I've shown you guys.
Page 9 sent $5.
Hold on 1 second.
What's on
Thank you so much.
Mind.
Thank you. Hold on, Spartan.
Your smile is like a breath of spring. Your voice is soft like summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep, and there's nothing I can do to keep from crying when he calls your name, Jolene. And I can easily understand how you could easily take my man, but you don't know what he means to me, Jolene.
Right, already showed a lot of tapes, and this bitch is getting fucking humiliated. And everybody's starting to realize who she is.
Who?
Yeah. You're gonna get quiet now. You fucking little dirty Jew. Yeah. Yeah, Lord's out of music now, bitch. You gonna respect me now, motherfucker? Huh? Oh, you little dirty Jew. You gonna respect me? You told me you love me and everything. You played your fucking most psychological games like a Nazi. My great-grandfather was a Nazi general, motherfucker. I'm gonna put you in your fucking place. Are you listening?
You know I lost Leaf King because of you?
Fuck you, motherfucker. You lost everything because you fucking tried to emotionally abuse me. And I'm gonna show all my everything because you tried to fucking deface me. When I was your friend, I was the most beautiful man to you. I was talking to you for hours. I was giving you so much advice. I was helping you. I was loving you. The irony of your sadistic levels, your sociopathic levels, getting so obsessed with me, getting so intrigued. But you're a sociopath, and you're so upset that I want to evolve and be a nice human being, be beautiful with people. You hate that. You're a demon. And I'm telling my psychiatrist about this. Not my psychiatrist. I don't take any medicine. Nobody take any pharmaceutical drugs. Please, go against that shit. Be strong in your own intrinsic value. Don't have PTSD. Be strong. And I'm going to tell you something, you fucking little whore. Nobody fucking trusts her. She's a fucking whore. She's coattailed from fucking Howard Stern, but her lips are fucking dwindling. She looks like shit without makeup. She has a fake
okay, and?
Nose. Yeah, no, I'm going to tell you the truth. This bitch is obsessed with me, man. I'm going to tell you the fucking truth. She's fucking in love with me.
Anonymous sent $3 Spartan is 47. Has a man bun, a push scooter, and wears Wonder Woman bracelets.
Totally.
Okay, no, listen, no more comment. She told me I'm the only one that bring all the content recently. She admits it. She admits she abuses me. But she's I'm gonna hate your ass, bitch. You're a fucking creepy fucking sociopath. This bitch was laughing with a happy tape with blood in his face, man. And she tried to cover it up. She's a creepy whore. I don't know why you guys are giving her money, man. She wants me to go right now because she says I'm the only mind-reading guy. Because this is what she does. She's a fucking whore. This bitch is thirsty. She says she only loves me. But you know what I'm going to tell you tomorrow, bitch? I'm going to turn your fucking whole chat out tomorrow. Look what you did tonight. Look what you did to me today. And you're going to pay the repercussions tomorrow, bitch. Don't say sorry. Don't ever say sorry to me ever again. You guys want this tonight. Everyone wants this tonight. So it's done, man. So now is a done deal. When I do IRL on Friday, everyone, when I do IRL, you're invited. I'm doing IRL on Friday. I'm going swanky.
Oh my god, it's good to see everybody. Great to see everybody here live on Permanent Friends.
Yeah.
You know, the number
one. I think I'm live.
And we've got the IRL queen here.
I think that's me.
That's you. Oh my god.
Okay. Wait, Virtuous Spartan?
Anonymous sent $3 chat type one eyed Spartan is on meth.
He's really mad at me. He used to be mad at me like this. Remember?
You were always mad at me.
Yeah, you were mad.
Oh my god, I cannot believe it. I guess I used to be in a different place.
You used to be so mad at me all the time.
A psychotic gaze. You know, I was dazed and confused, and I in the back of my mind, I didn't know what to believe. I was scared. I was scared out of my mind. You know. But I liked all of the attention.
You did?
I love the attention.
Wait, Spartan, please hold.
This is gonna be arch. This is gonna be perfected fine wine.
This He's gonna be us. He's gonna be perfected.
He's crazy, right? He's crazy. He's totally Tell crazy. Him to calm down. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Okay. All right. So, I want to introduce Eric. If you're unfamiliar with Kermit and Friends, he's like one of the biggest stars of Kermit and Friends. His name is Eric. And I worked with Eric in the gold industry.
Oh my God, your eyes are so beautiful.
Really? My eyes?
They're 10 times more beautiful in person than they are on camera.
Really?
But they are super beautiful on camera too.
Really? Oh, thank you. Oh my God. Yeah. That's so freaking nice. Wow.
It's true.
Really?
So yes, we worked together in the gold industry for like 3 months, 4 months or something like that. And then I left Los Angeles.
And we worked together. We got like a huge deal together.
We did a big deal together. That was a big deal.
I had this client that I would call over and over and over and over. They wanted nothing to do with me. Eric called the guy once and he closed a $300,000 deal. Eric, right here.
Right.
A $300,000 deal. And I got to be on it too. And it was so cool. Eric right now. So Eric closed this $300,000 deal and I was on it too. We got to make a speech in front of like 300 people.
It was a huge speech.
It was a
and
big
I remember
speech,
at the yeah. time that Elisa was like, you should propose to me live on stage in front of everybody with the whole world watching.
Yeah.
And get down on one knee in front of everybody.
Yeah.
But I didn't have the guts to do it at all. So all I did is I whispered in her ear. I said, will you marry me very quietly?
While we were on stage. Because they made us give speeches. Like whenever a deal went down in the company, you had to stand up there. It was actually very scary. Like,
yes.
I was totally scared out of my mind.
It was only recently that I finally worked out the kinks and I started to recover.
Yeah.
You know, I've been working as a baker in a bakery at a grocery store at Safeway, guys.
Yeah, you know, so he's working at Safeway now?
Yeah.
You
it are? It gives me a lot of time to like think through
I thought you were
in
insurance.
Stuff. I do insurance too.
Oh, okay. Yeah, oh, you're also in insurance?
I'm also in insurance.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
So I call people on the phone as well.
Okay, so you do like sales and also you work at a bakery. Okay, so you have two jobs. Okay,
two
that's
jobs.
Great. That's
two
awesome.
Jobs for the price of one. But it's not as awesome as the job that we had together for a little bit of time.
I know.
Do you miss being like the star of the show?
I mean, yes, I do.
Because the woman that you're talking to right now, I mean, you might not know this, but there's like a hierarchy in sales. And at the very top of sales is Wall Street brokers.
Yeah.
And there's people doing IRAs in stocks, commodities, mutual funds. And then there are people that compete with them that are in gold.
Yes.
And so in commodities. So this young lady right here actually was and is the top female gold broker in the world.
Yeah, I pretty much was
for a couple of years.
Yeah,
you know?
It was the number one precious metals dealer. And we were there and we were like pretty much at the top of the world. We had a 30,000 square foot office.
I mean, that office was just amazing.
And the windows,
I could like run around the whole
tower. Yeah, we would run around,
headset.
Yeah, yeah, and we were just like so confident on top of the world. Anyway, it all came crumbling down. But the nice thing is Eric and I kept in touch.
Yes.
And he became a part of Kermit and Friends, my podcast. And through Kermit and Friends, he met my friend Elaine.
Yes.
Okay, can you explain that?
But I also want to say, before I met Elisa, Kermit and Friends, there was no Kermit and Friends at all. You know, I met Elisa, and I think she kind of had a crush on me. You know, and so she had a podcast, and I hooked up with Claire. I hooked up with...
Lori Bolton.
Kleenex.
Lori Bolton.
Lori Bolton, who's single, by the way. She just texted me that her guy that she just broke up with him because he was a total dirtbag.
Oh, wow.
I can read back some of the text from Lori.
So Eric gets around, and then he eventually landed on Elaine, and they fell in love. How did that happen? Can you explain?
I fall in love with Elaine?
Yes.
Well, originally, I was going to come here, and I was going to meet you.
When?
Like
now?
No, like maybe a year ago or something like that.
And you never came?
I think I may have come.
You were here?
I was here for one day, one time.
When like Andy Dick was in the picture?
Yeah, it was when Andy was in the picture.
Was he like in RVs at the time?
He was, no, it was before the RV.
Oh, okay. So you were here and did you see Elaine then?
No, I didn't see Elaine then. This is the first time seeing Elaine.
Oh my God. So
and
guys,
this is the first time we're seeing each other in so long. Oh my God. I'm kidding. I'm really excited. She's got a lot of star power in person.
Really? Thank you. Okay, yes. Let's see what this person
says. Anonymous sent $5. Interesting, please. Some questions sent $3. Eric, welcome. How do you feel about small hats enslaving the entire human race?
What?
Do you feel any shame when you put your head on your pillow at night? Does your mind dream of exploiting for shekels and mass rape and torture of children?
Always, all the time. My head always explodes for mass rape and torture.
Nobody likes that. Nobody likes that.
My head down to bed.
Hey, look, I'm gonna put on a different filter. Hold on. Like these filters I have?
I love these filters.
Okay, so, all right, what were we talking about? Oh, yeah, so then you ended up in a relationship with Elaine.
Yes.
Somehow. Okay, so how did that happen?
You introduced me to Elaine.
I did? How did I do that? I don't remember doing that.
Elaine met you because you called Elaine because you were going to broker her IRA into gold, which would have been really bad for her, you know? But that's how you met Elaine. And then I'm sorry, I'm getting lost.
You are? You're getting lost in my eyes? Oh my gosh.
They're so pretty in person. They're so much prettier in person than they are on camera. But
really?
They're beautiful on camera.
But I use filters and everything. It can't be better in person. I don't think.
But
it's like impossible.
So that's how you met Elaine.
Through the gold business. Yeah.
And she
was on my hot list.
And then when we were doing Kermit and Friends, she became really active on Kermit and Friends.
Yeah, so Elaine would like book guests for Kermit and Friends, and she would, she was just really into it, like because of her, I know Wappy and a lot of other people. Mm-hmm. So I really appreciated that. And then we got involved with like Andy Dick and the IRL scene.
How is Andy doing these days, by the way?
He's good. He's around. Good. Yeah, he's around.
Okay.
Do you want to meet him?
I'd love to meet him.
You do?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
You want to meet Andy?
I love to meet Andy.
Oh my gosh.
I've been such a total asshole jerk to him so many
times in my life. I was just thinking that.
If I could meet him and I could tell him, hey, like, I'm really sorry for losing my mind on you.
You know, he has a really bad memory, so that's a good thing.
I'm sure you would remember that.
Yeah.
You know, being told that he's going to get killed, you know, by a Secret Service SWAT team or whatever because he has a mafia gang behind him or whatever kind of crazy shit I had going on at the time.
Exactly. Yeah, so you threatened Andy a bunch of times. You just didn't like me with him, I think. Like, you didn't think we were a good couple. Which I think you were actually right about that.
I just want to see you. Yeah. You know, I want you to be happy.
Sound like my mom.
Yeah. Do I think that you and Andy are a great couple? Sure.
You like,
do? Do I think that you and Mahasa are a great couple? Sure. You know?
Really?
I just want to see you happy.
My gosh. So are you staying with Elaine right now?
Do I really think that you and Mahasa are a great couple, though? I don't know.
He's Jewish, though.
He was kind of mean to you last time.
Yeah, he was so mean.
He ran off with your stuff.
He did.
And it's like, why wouldn't you be okay with Billy John coming in your car? I don't have any room in my car.
Yeah. Like, he did lie about that.
Is your penis really that small that you have to like... But Billy John might see how small my Jewish penis is from the back seat.
Well, not all Jewish penises are small because everybody saw yours, right? Eric used to send me nudes, and I have all his nudes still, and it was just, Eric's just such a great, I'm getting a caller. Kermit and Friends, IRL, Lisa and Eric, how can I help you?
Don't include Eric, because he's a fucking simp, but I like him.
You like him?
You like me?
Lisa, what kind of eggs do you like?
Why?
Do you like green eggs?
Because shut up, faggot, I'm at the store right now picking up eggs. Ooh, what kind of eggs do you like?
That's a very
wait, are you going to egg me?
I'm bringing you a present. What kind of eggs do you want?
I think he's gonna egg you.
I think I'm gonna get egged right now.
You're gonna get egged?
Yeah, I'm gonna be egged. Is that gonna hurt?
Do you want the brown organic ones?
Like in Sonic the Hedgehog, there's an Eggman.
Do you want the brown organic ones or do you want the white, the one, the extra large? I'll get an ostrich egg right now. Do you want an ostrich egg?
I know, I want the smallest ones they have if you're gonna egg me.
I'm bringing an ostrich egg.
Gonna throw
just,
it at
just
him?
One.
Just one ostrich.
Just one is okay.
Hey, that could be a lawsuit. You could win a big lawsuit.
Oh, yeah, that's a good point. This guy's probably broke, though. What'd you say, sir?
I'll see you in a bit at Hollywood Burger. I'm bringing an ostrich egg.
We're at Hollywood Burger.
That is where we are right now.
Wait, no, don't come here. Can you buy us a drink instead?
I love you, Elisa, but I'm sorry I have to do this.
I don't want to be egged. I really don't want to be egged. I don't, please.
I love you.
No. Nobody wants to be egged at. No.
It could be a good publicity stunt. You could go on TMZ for it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it could be like
okay, all right, so we're going to get egged. He knows where we are. Shoot, he named the exact place we are. Damn it.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate. Oh my God. Do you know that Leaf King is no longer?
What do you mean
he's no longer? He's not a fan of mine anymore.
He called me yesterday.
He called you yesterday?
He called me.
I
had a conversation with the Leaf King.
You did?
Yes.
What did he say?
Well, he said that Elisa's really excited to see you.
I am.
And was wondering if she could pick you up from the airport.
Yeah, I was going to. But now I'm like so afraid. I'm so paranoid right now. I'm so paranoid.
Like any of these cars.
Yeah, I know. Any of these cars.
Throw a giant ostrich egg our way.
Oh my gosh. I really don't want that. That because I get anxiety over like anything, you know? So that is like very anxiety producing. But yeah, so Leaf called you last night, but in between then and now. So I'll show you what happened.
Like your biggest fan. Now, I was expecting Leaf to be like an old, nasty, grumpy old guy.
Why were you thinking that?
But he's like some young hipster.
Yeah. Oh, he's a hipster? Really?
Like some young hipster that's our age.
Okay, so I'll show you Leaf King what he wrote yesterday. It's very bad. Okay. I really hate to say this, but you couldn't look more weak and pathetic than you do in that video that Spartan just posted. It's so disheartening to see you turn into this, Elisa.
Oh my God, he said that about you?
Yeah, Leaf King, yeah.
Wow, it's so disheartening to see you turn into this.
Yeah.
Now, which video is he referring to?
So Virtuous Spartan had a bunch of videos that he made of our phone calls. Like, he would, like, record our phone calls.
Oh.
And then
so
put it on his YouTube.
Do you talk to Virtuous Spartan, like, 24/7, 360? You do, don't you?
I used to.
Oh, my. Because when he tells it like it is on camera, and he says, like, you know, you tell me that we were going to have babies, and I'm going to get you pregnant.
Oh, I didn't say that. I don't want kids. Uh-oh.
Egg Gang sent $5.
No.
Don't get it twisted. This rap shit is my motherfuckers. Fuck what you heard. It's what you hearing. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. X gon' give it to ya. Fuck wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to ya. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. If the getting busy with it. But I got such a good heart that I make the motherfucker wonder if he did. Damn right, can I do it again? Cause I am right, so I got to win. Break bread with the enemy. No matter how many cats I break bread with, I break who you send to me. You motherfuckers never want to know what your life saved. Bitch, and that's all I like. Damn, give me damn. Fucking nigga set free. I'll be the one in the nut on his knee. Bitch, please. But the only thing you can't say is came out to play. Stay out my way. Motherfucker, we gonna fuck. Then we gonna fall. We let it pop. Don't let it go. He gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. He gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. But we gonna fuck, if we gonna fall. If we let it pop, don't let it go.
Okay, if you're just hanging out with someone, like just you and that person, it's fun. But then if you're like including all your other friends, that's what this is, and it makes it even more fun.
You're right. You're right. And all the precious moments
are captured.
Like, are captured. And yes. They're forever.
They're forever. Exactly. What I'm saying.
In a way that, you know, if the camera wasn't rolling, you would be like, what happened?
Yeah, was that like? I don't remember. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. That's how I feel. And Elaine, like, we just had so many funny, like, just moments together. And, like, you know, when she fell in front of Jim Carrey's house, that was hilarious.
That was great.
That
we
was
were just
so,
talking about that.
So funny and, like, amazing.
I still think that person that you met was Jim Carrey.
It was Jim Carrey. I know it was. You can meet like any celebrity around here. All the celebrities are here, so like if you wanted to meet somebody, we could just find that person. It's pretty easy.
Do you want to go interview people?
Do you want to do that?
Sure.
You do?
Yeah.
You want to do IRL?
Sure,
that's not what IRL is. You want to do that?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. All right. All right. Let's do that. All right. Where should we do that?
I don't know where we
go. Maybe like right here. Should we do it? Okay. Fine. All right. Let's do some IRL. How do we start? It's kind of like slow over here. I'm trying to think where we could go where people would be into it. Maybe the park. Should we go to like San Vicente Park? Actually, it's probably a good idea for us to leave right now because that egg guy.
Oh, you might egg us?
Well, I mean, we would avoid the egging if we go somewhere else.
It's true.
But yeah, like, I mean, I love IRL. It's like so fun. And I love to include my friends. Like, I'm trying to make this into a business. I want to hire people. I'm hiring Judy.
I see that.
Yeah. Like, I take it very seriously, and I was so excited, like...
You could even hire me one day.
I would love to hire you, but would you move here?
Sure.
You would?
Yeah.
You would move here?
For a good job like that, yeah.
It is a good job.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, my God. If I had you and Judy, like, I feel like I would be, like, the biggest IRL star because you guys are just so amazing. And, you know, Judy's giving me a dog.
I heard about that. You told us
about
that.
Yeah, Judy's giving me a dog, and so, I'm seeing her tomorrow. You could come, but you have to get along with
Mom.
So,
are you going to, I think I could get along with Ma.
You think you could get along with Ma?
I think I could get along with Ma. I think the thing about Billy John is that he like called Ma a bunch of like bad names.
Well, Billy John, like he uploads videos against people a lot, you know?
This is
and
so
then he,
cool. This
and then
is
he burns that bridge. Yeah, that's my selfie stick.
Oh,
like
this
that?
Is, I love that.
Yeah, I put some lipstick on. Do you like holding that?
Yeah.
You do?
Wow. This is so cool. So this is on IP2?
Yeah, so I'll show you how it works. So this is amazing. So a lot of people were like against me being on IP2.
Oh my God, your lipstick looks so great.
My lipstick looks good, really?
Yes.
A lot of people were against me being on IP2, like Leaf King.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody like tried to get me on it, but this guy Botter that like everybody hates, he wrote to IP2 for me to get on IP2. And then I was on it, and then, you know, I have all these viewers. I have 200 live viewers right now because of IP2. That's why. It's not because of anything else.
Yeah.
So Elaine, like, doesn't understand that. You know, she thinks it's just, like, very negative IP2. Mm-hmm. But she's wrong. Because if the fans of IP2 are not the same as the streamers of IP2. She thinks that the fans are, like, you know, just, like, a bunch of, like, drunk people.
But they're mostly, like, a bunch of retired people without anything
exactly.
Else to
they're
do.
Just, they're just
they
nice
just hang
people.
Out at home.
They're just nice, regular people that want to be entertained. And that's, like, perfect. My perfect demographic is people that that want to be entertained. I love entertaining people. I love it. You like that, right?
I love it too.
You love it too?
I love it too.
I mean, I would hire you, Eric, if you wanted.
Really?
Yeah.
I would take the job.
Wait, are you living with Elaine right now?
Yes.
You're living with Elaine? And she hates IP too. She hates it. And you're living with her? You moved in? Wait, did you move in all your stuff?
No. I'm just visiting. I'm here until Sunday.
Oh, you're here until Sunday?
Yeah, I'm here until Sunday, guys.
You moved in with Elaine. You gotta help me with Elaine. You have to help me. You have to broker this.
She's a,
You have to help me. I gotta get her back. I could tell she was very, like, scared when she saw me. She was, like, so afraid I was gonna, like,
I know,
pour alcohol down her, like, throat or something. Like, she thinks I'm trying to get her drunk, and I'm not even trying to get her drunk.
And Elisa says, you know, you could come, and we could just stream, and you could be off camera. And Elaine goes, you know what? How about I just drop Eric off, and you guys stream together?
She's so afraid of it. So weird. I don't know. I think it's weird, but maybe she'll change her mind. Okay, yeah. All right. Should we interview a nice, friendly-looking person? What should we interview them about? Let's see. Let's look for someone that can teach us. Hey, guys. How about this guy?
This seems like someone.
All right, Eric. You want to try?
Sure.
Oh, he said no. Oh, okay. We'll keep trying. We'll just go up to different people. How about this guy? Oh, everybody's on the phone. Everybody's busy today. Oh, man. All right. Everybody's pretty busy. We got to go somewhere where people are not busy.
Yeah.
Where would that be? Direction we're going towards Beverly Hills.
Okay.
Oh!
Thank you, Lisa, and hi, Eric. Send $5.
Cool. Ah! Alright, look here. Thank you.
Anonymous sent $5. Welcome to Kermit and Friends.
Thank you.
Smiley face, rainbow, confetti ball.
Thank you. This is not a nice one.
Yeah.
I am anti-gun. I'm really excited. That's just good exercise.
It really is.
Okay, let's go. Hold on. This is not nice. Can I just say stuff we could sing, like the Beatles would be good?
Beatles would be great.
If you guys want to sing the Beatles, we know that. I'll put my phone number in the chat. Take the call. The
really a good donation, really, because it's kind of negative.
Yeah. You're telling me.
Do you want to go to that coin thing tomorrow?
By the seat of her pants.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. This is a mean one. This is not a nice one. Moth season. Yeah, that's true. This is a long one, too. This is so long.
We kept so much footage of our rifle round.
Okay, so songs that we know are Beatles songs. What other songs do we know? Nirvana.
Yeah.
Britney Spears. Madonna.
NSYNC.
Summer Page
Boys.
9 sent $5 size 6. Size 6.
Size 6. That's Lala. She's talking about Lala right now.
Lala.
Oh, here's my song.
Lala's always on vacation. Even though she's never had a job, Lala wears a very tiny bikini. Even though she's a big fat slob, Lala always on her knees, Lala homeless and an RV, Lala. Big fat loser. Lala does nothing every day. Lala, take a shower before you blow another guy. You're gonna turn all the black guys gay. Lala, always on her knees, Lala.
JJ's flying kick sent $3. JJ put that location on the map when he maced the black dude when JJ was with his girlfriend.
You know JJ?
Do you carry Moss Mommy? LA is very dangerous. People from South LA travel there and commit crimes. You must carry mace.
Okay, I do have mace. The problem is I have so many things in my bag.
Anonymous sent $5.
Like damn, see how move. Like damn.
Like damn, see her move. 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 She lit, the money too. Like damn, see her move. In the mirror, I'm doing my dance. And you packing on nobody's pants. He a rapper, but don't got a chance. Stuck in my waist, so I'm loving my bands. Like a million views in a day. There's so many ways to get paid. I tried dipping, he begged me to stay. Babe, I'm not staying, I just wanna play. In the party, he just wanna romp. Big boobs in the bus, they plump. She a baddie, she knows she a 10. She a baddie with her baddie friend. They like, I tell you, always stay hot. Oh, they mad cause I keep making bops. Oh, she mad cause I'm taking her spot. If I was bitches, I'd hate me a lot. Like damn, she and her move. 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 She lit, get money too. Like damn, she and her move. No friends, I don't fuck with the fake. Saying they love me, but one in my place. Step in the party, I'm looking the baddest. Show the paparazzi in my face. Pretty bitch, but I came from the gutter. Said I'd be lit by the end of the summer. And I'm proud that I'm still getting bigger. Going viral is getting them sicker. Like what? Let's keep it a buck. Bitch too boring, I'm stuck in a rut. Lamborghini rolling with a hop at the truck. Pretty bitch like Lauren with a big ass butt. Yup, pretty face and a waist all gone. And I'm making them wait, hold on. And I'm making them wait, hold on. Wait, hold on. Like damn, see her move. 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 She lit. Get money too. Like damn, see her move. 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 She lit. Get money too. Like damn, see her move.
We're the coolest people on this boulevard. That's for sure. We'll be cooler than us over here.
Big Bob sent $5. We love your over-the-shoulder boulder holder. Release those borders, let them free. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy.
I actually took my bra off. Okay, so.
Distracting all the surfers, they forget about the tubes. No time for waves, let's talk about those boobs. You just can't miss her when she's coming your way. Just how big they are, it's hard to say. We want to get to know her, but there's hardly any room. Everybody wants to see bazooms.
I actually never heard this song before. See how easy this is? You can just live stream every day. It's so fun. So fun.
I hope we can find someone to interview.
I know, we need to interview a couple people. At least five people.
Maybe we can find someone who's like friends with them.
That's what we need. Exactly. You nailed it. You nailed it. I can tell these people aren't drunk enough yet. Maybe if we're like having so much fun, Elaine will watch and she'll be like, I need to be part of that. I gotta get it. Yeah, why am I not with that?
What am I doing?
Like, where is she right now? Just the, like, where, what's she doing? I know, but after that, like, what's she doing after that?
I don't know. Maybe you're gonna go home and take a nap.
Sydney Cat sent $5. Hooray. Fun stream.
Thank you.
Song always gets me dancing.
Okay, great. All right, we gotta dance. Thanks, Sydney Cat. Here, right here. We gotta sit here. Oh, this is a good one. We're gonna have a fun stream today. Very fun and positive and uplifting. Nobody can get us down. Let's try this angle. Much better.
Thank you.
Oh, well. Things are going very well. Should we call Elaine? Should we call her?
Did you say we're having so much fun, you gotta get over
Yeah,
there?
Let me get my phone. Wait. Try to call her. Wait, we gotta prepare what we're gonna say on the call. What should we say? Should we say, Elaine, we love you. We want you to be part of things. We don't want you to be burnt out. What should we say? I actually have no plan.
Yeah, I don't know what I could possibly say.
Did she say a lot of bad
things?
The
other thing is that she met up with Gucci, and Gucci said, told her, you know, don't get roped in with Elisa.
Gucci?
Gucci said that to her.
Are you sure?
Yes, totally threw you under the bus.
Gucci?
Gucci's, yes. The Gucci's.
Oh my god!
One of the first original streamers. She met up with Elaine in Florida. And she said that, don't get roped in with the Lisa.
What? Oh my god. What? Are you sure?
Yes.
Gucci?
Gucci said that. So
Jessica? The same?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, go on. So it's gonna be tough to undo that.
Wow! I'm shocked right now. I'm really surprised.
Black Lives Matter sent $5. Happy Black History Month, everyone.
Thank you.
Elisa, I hope you're showing support for the black community, especially those of us who have it really bad. Like this strong, well-spoken, young brother.
I've been just a stepdaughter since I was four.
Who is this
going
to be?
It's had a positive...
I can't believe that. I'm shocked.
If he's not the world's worst stutterer, then 27-year-old Eric May comes close. Every new syllable could set off a stuttering spasm.
I thought you'd say the opposite of that.
Negative part.
In my experience, he's one of the most severe stutterers I have ever seen. And I've been in stuttering for 20 years.
Okay, let's
stuttering
let's try this
is
part.
A
this
daily
part.
Torment for 3 million Americans.
All right, we'll pick up
what's
called.
Talking on the phone becomes a nightmare.
I can't believe that. I'm shocked. I'm in, shock right now. I can't believe Gucci's would say that. It doesn't sound like her.
It doesn't sound like her?
It doesn't sound like her to say that. She's a live streamer. She's been doing it for a lot longer than me. Much longer.
Brains to process speech. But brain studies show stutterers like Eric often use the right
you
side.
You don't stutter, do you?
And I
don't
think
so. Something
is wrong with the wiring that coordinates their speech muscles.
Stuttering John stutters.
Yeah, he does. Well, actually, he stutters a lot less.
Wait. They used to think it was a psychological problem because it really looks like somebody's nervous and that's where it comes from. But in the last
do I stutter?
Years,
they talking about me?
Research, and it's turning out to be a physiological problem.
You're looking beautiful.
Really?
Did I stutter when I said that?
No.
There are more male stutterers than female stutterers. It runs in families. So,
I know.
Most
all the stutterers
now,
I know are male, actually. That's true.
Into the world with
all the stutterers I know are male.
Something that somebody else
this is such a nice day.
Like
it's like a perfect day.
Or,
in Seattle, it's like cold, right?
Yeah,
do you have a nice place there?
Yeah.
You do?
Okay,
you know, Marianne is in there. She's there.
Marianne's in Seattle?
Marianne's in Seattle. I have a friend, Beck. Actually, Beck from IP2, I think, is in Seattle. And a couple other people I know. Oh, Kleenex.
Kleenex is there.
And who else? I know a lot of people in Seattle.
Thank you for introducing me to Kleenex.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah,
are you
really,
happy
yeah,
that I'm
really
introducing
cool.
you? Oh, okay, good.
It's really nice.
Oh, good. Yeah. You're going to meet so many people because of this. Like, the reach that I have now is much further than before. It tripled. Yeah.
It tripled. I've noticed that because before, you know, having like 1,000 viewers was like a big accomplishment. I remember the first
now
time
I have
had
like
1,000
viewers. I have like 6,000 replays, sometimes 8,000.
Yeah.
It's like amazing. I can't believe it, Eric. I can't believe it. And it was all due to just things kind of happening. I didn't plan, you know, for Andy. I didn't even plan for Andy to be on Kermit and Friends.
Yeah.
He was on there, and then through him, I just met all these people.
So when am I going to meet Andy?
All right, we can call him. We'll call Elaine. We'll call Andy. We have a few calls to make. We call Elaine. We call Andy. Who else should we call?
We call Lori.
Lori Bolton, yeah. She's coming here in March, I think.
I think she is coming in March, yeah.
Yeah. There we go to this park.
Hey, dog park.
That's a nice park.
So she's giving you a dog.
Oh, Judy, yeah.
When she told you that, what was your reaction?
Anonymous sent $3.
Did you say, you know what? You're right. I do need a new dog in my life. Or did you say,
Well, let me see if anybody typed 7. Because somebody just donated. They said press 7 if Elisa and Eric should hook up. I'm just curious if anybody typed 7. It's a little sunny here. Oh, somebody's calling. Oh, wait. See, it's hard to take callers and do all the... Oh, here. Oh, it's Virtuous. Hey, Virtuous Spartan.
Hey, Virtuous. How you doing?
Good. Thank you, Ray. Thank you for being polite like that. You know, hey, brother, I don't mean to... I pick up a lot of good vibes from you. This woman just has a lot of tension. I'm sorry. I know she kind of manipulated you in different ways. You seem like a sweet guy. You know, I know it's going to get controversial with you, but I don't want it to really go that way. This woman is very, man, bro, like a couple of days ago, we were on the phone 3 hours, the day before, not 3 hours. This woman has put me through a lot of torment.
Oh, yeah, she does that. But it's surprising that she's on the phone with you for so long. I mean, because a lot of guys, you know, when they tell...
She's a liar. She's a pathological liar. She's manipulative. Like, she just wants everybody to... She's like... I told her. I was like that... Like, I went in the rabbit hole the other day.
Yeah, but the thing about Elisa is she's not just a pathological liar. She's my pathological liar.
If you say anything fucking, like, remotely, fucking just strangles me, I'm an exception to the rule. She's very obsessed with me, and she knows I'm the fucking king.
It sounds like she actually is highly obsessed with you, Virtuous Spartan. I mean, and you might be the king, you know, as far as I can tell.
I don't want to be that. I just want to
try to help. You're like the king of the jungle, like the Lion King.
I don't want to be going to glory of this, you know, and I just want to try to evolve people, you know. And this woman is, she has a sociopathic way about her where it just really fucked me up so bad where I need to see a therapist in the last... You know,
oh yeah, no, her way of manipulating people and turning people into like toys in her game, I had to see a therapist too. You know, I've been seeing a therapist every like other week.
Unfortunately, she's still playing the game with me. You know, she still disrespect me, obviously, with you.
Yeah, I know. So, Elisa, you're so damn disrespectful.
What did I do? I don't remember doing anything, Eric.
She begged me, like, every day
she
always begged me. I'm sorry. Okay, you win. I mean, and no fucking friend, Jess, you're fucking parrot, fucking neurotic idiot. She's a fucking superficial, freak demon. And she changes... She doesn't even have a
plan. Anonymous sent $5 to Lisa and confused. How can you be engaged to Randy Jack when he's in prison or when he's making love to Billy John? Don't believe me? Listen closely to their sex scenes.
1 second, Spartan. There's some media playing.
1 second. He wears gay fucking... He's 56.
You know that's fucking... That's insane. Hold on. I should call Billy John, actually, right now. Hold on. I just stepped in mud.
What? I don't know how to jump in. Fucking piss. You're jumping into piss nothing. You're still getting in the obscure. You and me. I think that. You fucked that shit. You got fucking sick. I'm just Spartan. Yeah, treat me like a Spartan, baby. I want you to fucking make me suffer so I can resonate.
You're a silly...
Fuck,
no, I can't. Hear. Oh, here's a nice bench over there. Fucking dirty, fucking scummy,
fucking scummy. Just give me another fucking shirt, you fucking asshole. Okay. Oh, somebody's calling. I have a
regular car now. This one, see?
Just please hold.
I gotta go.
Please hold one moment.
You want one more boyhood? No, I give that to you. Hold on. I'll give you a different one.
I'm waiting for the don't know. To play. Oh, okay, yes, caller. How can I help you?
Hey, what's up? I'm a streamer. I want to collab with you, and I'm playing.
Oh, what's your name?
My name's Suspenders. I'm a #1 IRL streamer in Japan.
I saw you.
I'm gonna holler at you.
I'm gonna pass.
You saw him?
I saw him.
Where did you see him?
I'm gonna pass. A couple reasons. So, I don't think that we would work well together because you are a little flat. Your personality is a little flat for me. I'm sorry. You seem like a nice guy, though.
I'm a little what?
Like, your personality is like a little flat, like a little dull.
It's boring.
It's okay. It's okay. It'd be a little.
It would be a snooze fest if you.
It'd be. I think it would be a snooze fest. Yeah.
Chad, you got me mixed with somebody else.
What?
Chad, you got me mixed with somebody else. Have you watched my streams?
Wait, are you the guy with like? Are you the guy with like the hair that looks like Panic at the Disco, like from like the 2000s?
Yeah. From Japan.
You look like Fall Out Boy, right?
From Japan. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I know who you are. Okay, I know who you are, and I appreciate.
Come on, Shawty. You don't want to pick up no John. I mean, you can be my.
And I don't like the word John. Yeah.
You take this IRL game over.
No, I don't think that you're good at it. I'm sorry. I don't like it. I don't like you really.
I know I've seen how you like been looking at me since I started talking
to you. No. Thank you. Thank you for your call, sir. No, that guy's no good.
I think you should give him some credit. I mean,
it's nice of him for calling.
If he's got like a Flock of Seagulls haircut, you know, he can't be that good.
I don't like those haircuts though. I don't like the Fall Out Boy haircut in 2023. I don't like it. It's just over, in my opinion. But maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong. I'm a little old, so
that
might be why. Okay, so
you're like 23, 24.
Oh, Aaron, you're so cute. You're getting cuter and cuter. Okay, so where were we? Oh yeah, we were talking about Virtuous Spartan. You hung up, but so your question, I was gonna answer it. I want. Oh, here he is. Oh, yes, Virtuous Spartan. What's up?
Hi. Okay, I'd like to say a couple more things.
Okay.
You know, I want to elaborate on what you're saying about getting old. You know, the other day when you were saying, I realized you had an eye injury. You better not have your eye looking bad, otherwise I'm not going to be attracted to you. But you were pretty attracted to me anyways. And, you know, regardless if you're attracted to me for saying that, I don't give a fuck. You're a dirty fucking ugly pig inside your soul. And I'd rather have a woman that doesn't look like at me like that. Regardless,
right.
If you're very attracted to me now.
That's right.
Shit, bitch.
A dirty fucking ugly
pig. The only way you're going to like me. This woman begs me. She says she loves my bone structure. She loves everything about me. She loves my she, I'm funniest. Everything. She says I'm the best. And regardless, she wants to fuck me all this shit. To me, I already know this woman. I have her under my thumb. I can do anything I want at any moment if I wanted to. Yeah, but I'm really concentrating on myself, right? I'm putting my energy in myself because I know she's a worthless piece of shit. She's a sociopath. She manipulates and hurts people, and I hate that about her. For innocent, like, kids and stuff that go in her Discord. But I'm going to tell you one thing, bitch. I'm going to bring it down to your fucking knees like I told you in your fucking video in the beginning. My friend, I felt bad, man. He said, you know, this woman, give her a chance. It's very nice that the friend has a lot of money. He was gonna work with you, but he got to see your videos and he knows what a piece of shit you are.
Yeah.
He has a lot of money. He has millions of dollars, but you're a fucking idiot.
Oh, Weezy's calling. Hold on. I gotta get this. Hey, Weezy.
Hey, Weezy.
Weezy?
Hi.
Hi,
Weezy.
Oh,
how's it going?
God, it's Weezy. Yay. What's up, Weezy?
I'm watching your stream and I love it. And I just want to say, Eric is so great on stream. It's so great seeing you guys together. Especially after seeing him on the show for so long.
Anonymous
and
sent $5 slow dance.
He does really well with you.
Yes, I think Eric and I should be a team. An IRL team.
Andy, Dick, or Andy.
What? Wait, Weezy, are you there?
Yeah, I agree with you.
You agree?
You are a team.
Thank you, Weezy.
I love you.
Andy?
And I choke on my reply.
Wait, Andy, one second. I just have to do something. Let me take this from Andy real fast. Yes, Andy.
Andy. I got a weird call from your phone, baby.
You got a weird call from my phone?
Yeah.
What did they say?
It was a black guy, like being gay about Dick.
Okay, that wasn't me, Andy. It wasn't me.
Are you sure you're not a black guy?
No, it was from your phone.
I don't know, Andy. Andy, come to San Vicente Park. I'm here with my friend Eric. We're having a great time. And we're going to meet up with Elaine later.
Wait, is it my friend Eric?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, different Eric. No, he doesn't like that Eric.
Oh, okay.
Do you want to meet up with us, Andy? Where are you?
Yeah, I've been dying to meet you.
Oh, yeah. I might be able to meet you guys today. I just wanted to let you know about that phone call. It just happened. It was, like, really fucking weird.
I'm sorry, Andy. I love you. I would never do that.
Somebody hacked into your phone. and they're using your phone to call me.
All right, sweetheart. I'm going to call you right back. Meet me at San Vicente Park, Andy. I love you.
Love you, too.
Some tenderness survives. I'm just another writer, still trapped within my truth. A hesitant prize fighter, still trapped within my youth.
We're having a good time.
All right. So Andy might meet with us. Elaine, I think if Andy's there, maybe Elaine will come. She loves Andy.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
I think that's a good hook for Elaine.
You think so? Should we try? Should we tell her that Andy's coming?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to give Andy our address. He'll never be able to get. We have to pick him up.
We have to go get him.
Oh, God. I always have to pick everybody up. And I don't even have a car. And I'm always pick everybody
up. What happened to your car?
I don't know. All right.
Did you crash it?
Wait, when you knew me, I had a car?
Well, I bought a car, and then you bought a car.
I did? Like the little one?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I used to have a little tiny car. It was so cute. And then I didn't like it. So
you sold it?
It's just a lot of, I don't know. It feels like a lot of responsibility.
Having a car, yeah.
Having a stream, having a car, having anything. I can't.
You get to have a car, though. You get to have all these things.
I do? Yeah,
yes, you do.
Should I get a car again?
Yes.
All right.
You can have a car.
Okay.
You can have a yacht.
I can?
Yes.
I should work harder. I should 10X this stream.
Let's 10X this stream.
So Eric and I took Grant Cardone University.
Cardone U. We're both graduates of Cardone
U. We're both graduates of Cardone U, which is a course, or many courses.
Many courses on finance.
On finance, sales. So we're like sales experts. So Eric and I went through this whole thing, and it's like a $30,000 course.
Yes.
That our company paid for. And it was, I guess it taught me some things. I mean, when I want somebody to do IRL with me, I call them like 100 times the way I would a gold prospect.
And at some point they answer.
Yeah, at some point they will answer, like Judy C. But
Judy's 100.
That's where we're meeting Judy tomorrow at Blue Water Grill.
Blue Water Grill.
And she's going to do a stream with us. I'm going to hire her.
Aww.
But now I'm like, now that I'm hiring people, now everybody wants to be hired.
Yeah,
I'm like, how big is my staff going to be? But if I streamed every day, I could make that work. So
you definitely could.
If you streamed every day.
Like hours and hours on end.
Yeah,
Like Captain Content.
Or
Ice Poseidon.
Oh my God,
Ice
Poseidon.
Whose stream is on 24/7, 365.
Ice Poseidon.
Isn't it?
Yeah, he just started doing that. Yeah.
Yeah.
We could go to Japan.
Let's go to Japan.
Would you like to?
I'd love to go to Japan.
You'd be a great Japan partner. I want to include Elaine, though. If you're going to marry Elaine, she has to be part of this. I can't just be going to Japan with you and Elaine doesn't come. She has to come.
I know.
So do you see the problem here?
There's a little bit of a conflict of interest, but
I see a big conflict of interest right now. Huge. If we're traveling everywhere, doing IRL, having fun, singing, dancing, like meeting people, interviewing people, like, and then Elaine, what's she going to be doing? She's going to be home watching us.
The thing about Elaine is a little older, Elisa. So maybe that's the most she can do is be at home watching us.
No, but she was an IRL star.
But
she
got tired. What if she had a heart attack one day? How terrible would you feel?
I would feel bad. I don't think.
If she was like, you know, people were making fun of her for pooping herself, you know, on the beach, you know, and then.
But that could happen really to anyone.
Yeah. So, anybody could get hit by lightning.
Yeah, but anyone could have an embarrassing moment. I've had so many embarrassing moments. One time
at. You never pooped yourself on the beach.
It could happen.
It could happen.
At any point.
We got to go to the beach right now.
Yeah. No. It's a little chilly, but it's going to be nice next week. You're not going to be here next week. Aww. Let's see.
Hugh Eric. Elisa will never let you smash. Send $5, Eric. You're in the friend zone, bro.
What's up?
Yo,
I got a little story to tell you.
Have you ever met a girl that you tried to date, but a year to make love, she wanted you to wait? Let me tell you a story of my situation. I was talking to this girl from the U.S. nation. The way that I met her was on tour at a concert. You had long hair and a short mini skirt. I just got on stage to perform with sweat. I was walking through the crowd, and guess who I met? I whispered in the ear, come to the picture room so I can ask you some questions and see if you're 100 proof. I asked her name, she said, blah, blah, blah. She had 9 pants and a very big bra. I took a couple of flicks and she was enthused. I said, how do you like the show? She said I was very amused. I started throwing bass, she started throwing back mid-range. But when I screamed the question, she had to kind of scream. Then when I asked, do you have a match? She tried to pretend. She said, no, I don't. I only have a friend. Come on. I'm not even going for it. This is my own thing.
I'm just a friend.
You got what I need.
But you say I'm just a friend. They say I'm just a friend.
Oh, baby,
you got what I need. They say I'm just a friend. And they say I'm just a friend. Yeah, baby, you got what I need. And they say I'm just a friend.
Familiar, spending a lot of time so we can build up relationships and some understanding how it's going to be in the future.
All right, Kenneth, yes, how can I help you?
Hey, Ken, how you doing?
What is up, sweetheart?
I'm just with my friend Eric right now, Lane's boyfriend, my friend, just hanging out in the park. What are you doing?
I haven't had a chance to really talk to you in a little while.
Well, I'm so glad you called.
Yeah.
Are you watching the stream?
I haven't had a chance to really watch it all the way through, but I'm going to.
All right, great. Do you know that Eric is dating my friend Elaine, and we're trying to figure it out, right?
Yeah, we're trying to figure it out.
It's very confusing. I'm very confused because Eric is dating Elaine, and Elaine walked away, and I would have loved to hang out with her, too.
Yeah, we want to get Elaine back on the stream.
We need to get Elaine back, but we don't know how to do it. Ken, do you have any advice on how we can get Elaine back?
Yeah, Ken, we're lost without you.
I can't think of any right off the top of my head, but let me see. I don't know.
No. All right, call back when you know, Ken. Yes, how can I help you?
Yes, hi. I'd like to leave a message for the audience today that is watching the show.
Okay.
Okay, what do you got?
Okay, Virtuous Spartan, if you're listening, my friend Eric, the guy with the glasses in the show, said if you come down there right now, he's going to kick your ass.
All right. I had to hang up. There's no violence on the stream.
I would definitely kick Virtuous Spartan's ass in a heartbeat. I would go off on him. Just like the good old days. You know?
You would?
Just like the good old days.
You're not a fighting person.
Oh, I know.
You're not like that, Eric.
I know.
You're not a violent guy. Right? You're not.
I'm not.
Are you?
No.
Okay. Kermit and Friends, IRL, Lisa and Eric, how can I help you?
Hello, Lisa and Eric. This is Fatima. How are you doing?
Oh, hi Fatima. Thanks for calling in. What's up?
Yes. Oh, hello. I was calling about you were talking about Elaine. You're having a problem getting her back into IRL.
Yes.
That's our main problem right now is getting Elaine.
That's a big problem.
To be a co-host and co-star again.
Yeah, she has a little sick of the mud. Maybe, do you think maybe she wants some money?
Yes, she did ask for money, but the thing is like if she was just asking for money, we could give her some money, but like right now.
Yeah, we could split the donuts.
Yeah,
we could
do something. We could pay her hourly. That's fine. But I think she's like upset with IRL. I don't think it might be monetary. She did ask for money at one point, but it's also that she had a lot of embarrassing moments, but we all do. I'm embarrassed. Like every time I go live, it's embarrassing, right? Everybody's embarrassed. So you just have to learn to go through the embarrassment. Like if you do anything that people see, if you're a singer, if you're an actor, if you're a dancer, if you're a comedian, you're going to be embarrassed at some point. So she just has to get used to that, Fatima. It's just part of it.
I know. I would love to see her dance. That would be so
She's a great dancer. She's like one of my...
Yeah, she is.
Yeah, she's a great dancer. She's one of my favorite dancers, my favorite performer. She's dating Eric, who she met through me.
Yes.
The least she could do is just have a little fun and do a dance.
She owes at least one dance.
Fatima, I completely 100% agree with that.
Yes. Elaine, if you're watching, please come back. Come, please do some entertainment for us. We miss you. We like your dancing. I would love Elaine. She's awesome.
Thank you,
Fatima. Love you so much. You're so wonderful.
What a, yes, take care, you guys.
Take care. Wow, that's Fatima. See, like,
that was awesome.
Elaine is missing out on people like Fatima. Do you see
who are her biggest fans in the whole wide world?
Yeah, like, so do you see, like, how can people miss this? That's what I don't understand. Like, when people don't want to be a part of it,
yeah,
I'm like, okay, let me just explain it very simply. Like, you would not know Fatima if there was no IRL. Yeah, I would not know Fatima. And many other people I would not know. Yes, how can I help you? Kermit and Friends, IRL, IP2, customer service, how can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to leave a message for Virtuous Spartan. Eric would like to reiterate the fact that he will kick your ass.
All right, no violence.
Yeah, I'll kick his ass. You know, heartbeat.
Exactly, Devin. Like, Devin, all these people.
Even though I'm pretty non-violent.
Yeah, you're not violent. Okay, like, Devin, Fatima, all the women, Penny. I can name so many women right now that are Elaine fans. And I truly feel, like, next week I could go visit my friend Penny in Arizona if I want.
Penny in Arizona?
Penny, yeah.
And she would be, would she fly you out?
I could get there somehow.
You could get there.
And I could go visit her and I could have fun. In like Tucson City, like I can have fun over there because I know Penny because of IRL. I can go to Destin and visit my friend Sarah, who invited me to stay in her house.
Yeah.
Destin, Florida.
Destin, in Florida.
Yeah.
Are you gonna go there from Rob's place?
That's a good question. Yes, IRL customer service, how can I help you?
Alright, you shut your little fucking parrot voice, friend gesture fucking voice down right now, okay? You're gonna listen to me right now.
Damn, I'm
you
surprised
you
put up
just
with that one.
Manipulative, calculating little sparrow
but
bitch.
But I guess I'll have something to say that's crazy enough to work.
And you just show. Have people that placate to you. You don't have no value as a woman. You're just like a piece of shit. You just like want people
true.
To... I
mean,
true.
So little value as a woman.
Put you on a pedestal. And you used and abused me because I was the most... strongest man that has sensitive feelings towards you.
Yeah, you had to pick the strongest one to pick on.
And why are you putting me on the phone with her? Him? See, that you disrespect me now, bitch. You're never going to go back from this ever again.
Spartan, we're broken up. We're not talking anymore, Spartan.
Okay, yeah. Oh, we're broken up, so never beg me like last night. Never beg me. Never call me. Never tell me how much you love me. I'm gonna
you
fucking call, expose
you called him
all
last
the sexual
night and told
shit.
Him how much you love
gonna,
him
no,
after
wait,
you broke
I'm gonna
up
expand.
With him.
No, I was trying to hold back on the sexual shit, but now I'm gonna expose all the sexual shit. I'm gonna do all the recordings.
Oh, Penny's calling. Hey, Penny.
In Penny Lane, there is a dot.
Penny.
Hi.
Hi. Oh my God, I was just telling Eric about you.
I know. I was watching, actually.
Yes. I was telling him, like, I'm so happy that I know you and I could go to Arizona and I could hang out with you. And...
Oh, cool.
Yes,
is he in Phoenix?
Absolutely. We'd have so much fun. And Eric should come to Arizona, too.
Really?
Yeah.
I'd love to.
We could go to Arizona. We'd have so much fun. It would be wonderful.
Oh, my gosh. We would have the best time. Oh, and the weather is so nice here. So it would be perfect for IRL.
It'd be perfect for IRL.
Can
Did you
not,
hear that?
Yeah. I'm like, you don't know how sad I was. Like, the last 2 weeks, I didn't have anybody to IRL with. I didn't have anywhere to go. I was just by myself. I didn't, like, I felt so hopeless.
Hopeless?
Yeah, I did.
Oh. How could you feel hopeless?
You guys should come here.
You've got
it. You want to go there? Let's ask Elaine if she could.
And we want Elaine. You know, Elaine really needs to, like, just loosen up and realize that we're all just, like, a minuscule micro piece of sand in this massive universe.
Yes.
Nobody's going to care. You know, no one's going to judge her.
Yeah, I feel that way. Care. Everyone loves Elaine. Like, you love Elaine. Everybody loves Elaine. Like, what does she not see? Like, we could go to Arizona. We could stream. We could have the time of our lives. Like, you don't know when this all is going to end.
It could all end. You don't know.
So we might as well enjoy
it's
it while
so
it lasts.
True.
All right, Penny. I'm going to work on Elaine. I'm going to call Elaine right now and ask her.
Okay, you guys. You're doing a great job. Love you.
Thank
guys.
You.
Okay,
love you
so much.
See, Penny loves us.
Aww,
Penny loves us. Sweet. This woman in Arizona.
In Arizona.
Who's so nice and who is inviting us there.
See, and that's who
loves
I.
Loves us.
That's
you
who
see
I see.
How crazy that
that's
is.
Who I see, like, our fans being. You
know, yeah,
like, our,
me too.
Like, our fans that are watching are just like that. You know,
exactly like Penny. Like Penny's like the
sweet,
perfect,
easygoing,
yeah.
older crowd, you know, with nothing to do at home, you know. That.
But I don't have anything to do.
Oh,
it's Bob. Yes, IRL, how can I help you?
Hey, Trumpster Bob.
Hey, man, what's going on? I just want to say I think Eric
and Alicia, y'all should do like a Alicia and Eric power show or so. Y'all are so
Anonymous sent $3. Eric, I hope Elida reciprocated and sent some noodles pictures back to you after you sent them
noodles
to her.
Noodles pictures.
I didn't send any nudes. Yeah, Bob. So you like Eric? Are you a fan?
Oh, I'm a new fan all over again. Hello, Eric. Oh, really? Man, y'all are great together. I love you two together. Y'all are awesome.
Thank you, Bob. Love you so much, Dumpster Bob.
Love you too, Bob.
See,
that is so cool.
Don't you
that is
love
so
that?
Cool because we've been hanging out with Bob now for how long has it been? 2.5 years. Something
yeah,
like that.
I remember
when you became a Trumpster Bob fan and you were watching all of his stuff like all night long obsessively. Yeah. And eventually you started having him on. You were on Drunken Peasants and he was on Drunken Peasants.
Yeah.
And then you had him over from there and then all the way to today.
I know. And we're still, look how cool that is. So what I want Elaine to see, which I don't think she sees, is the connection that you can have with people can be so broad. Like, we just spoke to Penny. She was so nice. We just spoke to Trumpster Bob. He's in Texas. He's so nice. Like, we can travel all over the world.
Yeah.
Connecting with people. Like, spreading joy.
Yeah.
Like, what is better than that? Tell me what is better. I cannot think of a better idea.
I can't think of a better idea either.
All right. So, let's tell Elaine. You want to call her from your phone?
Sure.
Okay. So, we're going to pitch to Elaine right now that we drive to Penny.
Penny.
She knows Penny.
Florida. She knows
Penny? No, not in Florida. In Arizona.
In Arizona.
And we could go after the coin convention. What do you think? Do you like that?
I love that.
You love it?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
I have to see if I could get some time off at work, you know.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Can you explain to Elaine how great it is? How many people that you're talking to, how many people love her? You don't have her number?
I know it by heart.
Okay.
So we're going to go see Penny in Arizona.
Yes. And Penny wants to see Elaine.
Hi, this is Elaine. Sorry.
Oh, she didn't even answer.
Should we leave a message?
Yeah.
Mailbox is full.
Mailbox full.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Maybe we should start smaller. Maybe we can have Elaine go to the coin convention tomorrow.
Yeah.
Would that? Do you think there's any shot of that happening? Any shot? I don't think there's any shot. I don't think there's. It's like it's such a small percentage of chance. All right, well, okay, who else should we call? Let's see. I'm scared to call everybody. I'm scared to call Moss and ask him about the coin convention.
Oh yeah.
Here's Bruce. Yes, IRL customer service, how can I help you?
Hey Lisa, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
It's Bruce.
Hey Bruce.
Hey Bruce Springsteen.
Hey, you guys are having a great time. You guys look good together.
Thank you.
Thank
yeah,
you so
we're
much.
Having a fun time.
We're having a lot of fun.
Hey, I wanted to ask you a question. There's a really cool streamer by the name of Rooster Doll. I don't know if you know, she
Rooster Doll.
Shows your videos. You can look her up on the
Do you have a question, Bruce, or do you have a thought?
It's Rooster Doll.
Rooster Doll.
Listen,
I'll text it to you. I'll send her. I'll text you.
All right. Thanks for your call. Yeah. Thanks for your call. Right. Don't call. Don't call like that.
Rooster Doll. No, I'm interested.
Yeah.
Let me look it up.
Yeah.
Rooster Doll.
Yeah. Rooster Doll. That was Bruce.
No, I'm interested.
So, what else is happening?
Do you want me to come to the coin convention with you and Moss?
I mean, yeah, that'd be great. I don't know how Moss... I'll tell Moss. Let me see what Moss says. It's so hard with, like, Moss and Elaine. It's, like, fucked up, right? Like, you can't even be friends with anyone. Like, Moss Moss is going to be jealous that you're there. And what? I think Elaine's going to be upset that I'm there.
Well, I'm in a committed relationship with Elaine, so there's nothing to be jealous
about.
Yeah,
exactly,
about
exactly. And I'm going to...
And I'm in a best friend relationship with Elisa.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, how can I help you?
What's up, DJ Darren? Elisa, looking lovely today.
Thank you.
Isn't she looking beautiful?
Thank you. I dressed up to see my friend Eric. Yeah.
That dress is on point today.
Thank you. Yeah, I've been...
I just joined in the chat and stuff. Who is this handsome young man you're hanging with?
So this is Eric. He's a former colleague of mine, current boyfriend of Elaine. Do you remember Elaine?
Yeah.
So Elaine... quit IRL. She doesn't want to do IRL anymore. And she walked away this morning when I saw her, and she was wanting no part of it. But we're trying to convince her because our friend Penny wants us to go to Arizona, and she wants Elaine there. And, you know, a lot of people want to see Elaine. And everybody's like, Elaine, Elaine, Elaine. I'm like, there's nothing I can do. There's nothing. I've been trying. I've been trying to get Elaine back, and I don't know how to do it.
I think it's a slow process, you know.
She just don't want to do any IRL or be on stream anymore.
Yeah, she doesn't want to be on stream. She's very upset about things that happened. But we had a great time when we...
But then sometimes you, like, backlash at her and you say that she's always stealing your men. You know, like...
Well, I mean, I did notice that.
You bring up stuff like, you know, oh, you know, I went through your phone and you were dating Captain Content while I was dating Captain Content, you know, and you bring up stuff like that. And
well, okay, so that is true,
it throws her, but it throws her for a loop.
No, but why would she do that? Why would she do that, though?
I'm surprised that you're even talking to her.
No, but why would she text Captain Content when I'm going out with him and say, oh, are you really a captain? Where's your ship? That's weird. Like, that's a weird text.
Maybe Elaine doesn't have, you know, you got to have a certain toughness to be on stream in IRL. Maybe, you know, Elaine's, I don't know the total situation, but, you know, you got to be pretty tough to be on stream.
I don't mind. Okay, here's the thing.
Thick skin.
I want Elaine to experience the benefits of doing IRL. I want her to be excited about meeting the people through it. And I know she is, and there's proof of that. But it's just weird. Like, she wants all the benefits, but she doesn't want to be a part of it. It's like weird. Like, okay, so she's gonna take Eric. You know, like Eric. Yeah. Eric is in her home now. You're in there. You put your stuff in there.
A backpack.
Okay, so he put his backpack in there. You know, but she runs away from me. But she met him because of me.
Well, yeah. She's still your bestie. You
really?
Know? Yes.
But she told you that I said what?
I said to her even earlier today that who was her bestie? John was her bestie.
Who's John?
He's like an agent that lives in her building. And she goes, no, Elisa's my bestie.
Okay, so then where is she? Why is she not here, Eric? Where?
Because you have a camera on.
No, but she could sit. I told her, don't sit on the camera. You could sit. Oh, she could be sitting over there and the camera won't even be on her.
And she just doesn't want to film the whole escapade.
No, but she doesn't have to be on it. Yes, how can I help you?
Are you going to be begging tomorrow? You're going to be saying I'm the best Spartan? Sparty! I love you the best out of everybody. Don't worry about this effeminate guy I'm going to be seeing. Don't worry about Leaf. That motherfucker kisses my ass. Don't worry about cleanness. He's a fat fucking...
Leaf is gone because of you, Spartan. Leaf left.
Let's talk about all the individuals. He'll be back.
He's not in the chat. He's not in the chat.
And I'm trying to Where did he go? We should call him right now.
What did I show on your Discord last night? I turned your fucking whole chat out, right?
Leaf left my community because of you. It's your fault.
Because I told the fucking truth about your sociopath ass. Because you're trying to fucking break me down. The irony of a good man trying to fucking treat you right. Fuck you. You have the right. Yeah. You think you have the right to fucking treat me like shit? Just because I'm a nice guy? You think you're going to fucking mastermind me? No, fuck you, bitch. I'm going to fucking do a lot more worse to you. I'm gonna do a lot more worse to you. You still have the audacity to tell me that? I did this to you? You're the one that was trying to fucking break me down.
No, I wasn't.
Make me fucking all myself, telling me you love me? Oh, fucking string me along this all this time? You fucking sociopath? You're gonna get A game. I swear to God, bros, I'll fucking pay
That's right, you're gonna get A game.
We're gonna egg this fucking bitch.
You're gonna pass out fucking little
fucking
pre-tension. Oh, so
they're all on this egg. I'm gonna fucking break your fucking face with the fucking egg in your fucking nose.
Oh no, that's not good. That's not good
this
at all.
This fucking evil sociopath. She has no fucking conscience.
Summer Page 9 sent $5.
He has bad bugs. Lives in a car. Of every
things look dirty, it's because they are. He has tons of maggots. His belongings stay in a jar. I am afraid to sit on his couch. The luck trying to figure him out. He cries like a bitch when he gets the check. Drive out to Andy, I don't want you back. He got a haircut from the crib. How am I supposed to take you on a vacation? If you would have just listen to me, you wouldn't be looking for only food that's free. We'd be at Four Seasons, where we belong.
I was right about everything in that song.
I love that song.
I love the part where it goes like, by now you'd be writing me a breakup song.
Yeah.
I was right.
It's true.
Yeah, it's so true.
So damn true.
Okay.
What's the name of that song?
I don't want Cappy back.
I don't want Cappy back.
I wrote another song about Spartan. I think it's pretty good. Let me see if I could put that in the chat. Oh, Darren. Oh, hey, DJ Darren. DJ Darren?
Yo, what's up?
What's up?
I love that hit. That's such a hit.
Such a hit, right?
I was on your show when you dropped that hit. That was hilarious.
Yeah, I loved it. I was so inspired at that time. It was this wonderful time in my life. One of the best times.
It's really fucking good, man. It's hilarious.
Thank you.
So you didn't say, who is this guy sitting next to you?
Oh, this guy's sitting. Okay, so this is Elaine's boyfriend. Do you know Elaine?
Oh, okay.
This is her boyfriend.
So he likes the older ladies then?
This older lady? Yeah.
I mean, I guess he does, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
No problem. No, I like this guy. I got a good vibe. You know, I hate most everybody, but I like this guy. I got a good vibe from
yeah,
this
he's
guy.
The How nicest guy. I just love him. He was my favorite when I worked in an office with him. There was 300 people working there, and he was my favorite by far.
All right, I got a good vibe already, man. And you know, if I fucking don't like somebody, you know I say it.
Oh yeah, I know. Thanks, yeah. DJ Darren, you're the best.
Yeah,
I appreciate it.
What are you guys doing today?
Well, I don't think we're hanging out with Elaine. Are we? I don't know. We don't know. We're just chilling at the park, and we're walking around. We're gonna interview people.
In Los Angeles.
Yeah. We're just in Los Angeles. We're at park in West Hollywood, and we're just singing and dancing and having fun. Tomorrow I'm going to a coin. It's a beautiful day. Tomorrow I'm going to Long Beach to a coin convention at the Convention Center, collected coins and sports memorabilia. Yes, how can I help you? Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, how can I help you?
Yeah, so why you've been absent for 10 days, and then now all of a sudden you're streaming with this gay guy?
Oh. He's not gay. Oh. He's dating my friend Elaine. And
okay,
I...
Low blow.
He's super feminine, though. Not mine.
I don't think he's gay at all, sir. The reason why I haven't been streaming, I didn't have anyone to stream with. I went to a meeting with Alki David.
Nah, you've been going out with that lawyer.
No, I haven't. No, Eddie. He's talking about Eddie.
Talking
but
about Eddie. No, the one that you job interviewed with.
Just hold on 1 second. That's a good question. Yes. Oh, never mind.
Hey, did you ever get called back from that job interview?
I did not. I'm sorry, sir. Let me answer that question. So the reason why I didn't stream was because I was prospecting. A big part of sales is prospecting, looking for people to work with, right?
Yeah, you've been prospecting his penis.
Wait, hold on. Yes, yes, how can I help you? Yes.
That was a good one.
What?
I said, how you doing?
I'm doing well, how are you?
What's this?
I'm doing great.
Anonymous sent $3. This is for Eric. It's not cheating if you don't get caught. Hit it and quit it.
No. I would totally get caught.
Yeah,
you would totally get caught, my brother. It's all good.
So who is this? What is your question, sir?
This is Diesel.
Diesel.
I just want to say, how you doing?
I'm good. Okay, how can I help you? A lot of people call.
Hey, Lisa, how you doing?
Good, who's this?
Yeah, who's this?
This is Margaret.
Margaret, you're a new caller. Nice to talk to you. Any thoughts on the stream so far?
I just want to say that he's a really nice guy. Eric is a really good guy.
Oh, thank you, Margaret.
I agree with you. I 100% agree with you. He's a great guy. He's a great catch. I hope him and Elaine are very happy together. Yeah. But I'm missing out on a lot of things with
by not having Elaine on the show.
I hope so, too. You guys make a really good couple.
Yeah. So Eric did propose to me when we worked together. I forgot what happened. I forgot what I said.
You said yes.
I did? Yeah. I said yes?
Yeah, and then you put on a ring.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, that ring. Yeah. I have that.
You still have that?
I have that, yes.
You still wear that sometimes?
Oh, once in a while. What'd you say, ma'am?
Once in a while.
When's the wedding?
When you're feeling really down.
Well, he's dating my friend Elaine right now, so it's a little confusing.
Oh.
So we just have to figure that part out. But, yeah, Eric did propose to me. I was wearing a ring, and then somehow he's dating my friend.
Okay.
So we just have to...
We've been dating.
Who?
Elaine and I.
Congratulations.
Okay.
Time.
Okay, thank you, Margaret. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What a nice lady. Okay.
Margaret, that is super sweet.
Yes, DJ Darren.
I'm back.
You're back.
Back in action. Batman is back.
So before we rudely interrupted, yes, so you're having a beautiful day in Long Beach at the coin show.
Oh, yeah, we're going to the coin convention. There's a coin convention and sports memorabilia convention in Long Beach. And then in Newport Beach is our old colleague, Judy. I'm hiring to be my assistant in IRL because I need help. This is not easy. Do you see? This is not freaking easy, Eric. Do you realize that? Do you see?
Yeah, I see.
It's fun, but it's
it
like...
It is. It's a lot of work.
It's so much. There's so much that goes into it. I'm telling you.
So you got Spartan on one line. You've got Elaine not showing up.
Yes.
It's a
full-time job. Oh, my God. Andy. DJ, you nailed it. Yeah, I have Andy. I have Spartan. I have
all
Eric.
All these people who are
a
handful.
Yeah, I have... Elaine is like...
You got somebody who can be like your new sidekick, like Judy.
Yeah, I think Judy could be good because
could be your new sidekick.
So Judy was going to take a job at a car shop, and they were paying like I think like $16 an hour, like minimum wage.
Like nothing.
No, so I said I'll just pay you that.
Mm.
And then you just hold. You know, you don't even have to hold my speaker. You just be there.
Yeah.
Just be there.
Hey, Lisa.
Yes.
I got a special request for you.
Yes.
Would you reconsider modding my homie Edward Kim?
I thought he was a mod.
Modding your homie Edward Kim?
No, he said he's unmodded or something.
Oh, that's so weird. Okay, yeah, sure, I'll look into that. No problem. I thought he was
a
mod.
He's a fucking real one, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, he's a nice guy.
He is. He's a good fucking guy.
Okay, all right, okay, I'll do it right now. I didn't realize that. Here, let me just go into my, I'll remod him. I don't know what, maybe I made a fake Edward Kim mod. That's bad. That would be bad
How
if I did
make
that.
Mod?
I don't know. Wait, everybody stop calling me just so I could do this Edward Kim thing. Edward Kim. Here he is. I found him. Added moderate. Okay, here he is. Oh my God, here's Eddie. Eddie, what's up?
Who's Eddie?
Oh, it's fake Eddie. Oh, I was so excited.
Thanks for stopping by.
I was so excited. Oh my God. I was so excited Eddie was calling me. All right. How did somebody get his number? All right. What was I just doing? Oh, yeah. I wanted to show you guys my new song. Oh, here's...
You have a new song?
I have a song. Yeah. If somebody wants to donate...
You know what, Lisa? For you wasting all my time and doing all this, I really, really am going to go at my best to really try to humble you. You know that?
What does that mean, Spartan? What does that mean?
Wait. Let me tell you what it means. I'm going to do all I have to do. A lot of people in your chat Discord, everybody knows that I was in the right, and I proved it when I bring out those hidden messages that I recorded when you weren't aware of it, and I proved that you were a sociopath abusing me for so long, stringing me along, obsessed with me, and you said so many things about me. You said I was the most handsomest, you said I was the smartest, I was the funniest, you loved me, you were intrigued by me, you gravitated by me. That's how we met, through the chat, because you said a little Spanish chat, you love my comments and everything.
when I reached out to you, I was surprised. I reached out to you, and you said, "Hey, Spartan, I love you." And I was like, "Wow, I'm smitten. You know, this I'm flattered. This woman likes me. Like, I kind of, you know, I think she's funny, but I'm not into your
I think
your
she likes you, Spartan.
Lips, your lips
you know?
Are, you're like an old.
I think there's a reason why she
lady.
Answers your call.
Wait,
maybe
wait.
She likes
oh,
you.
Yeah, I'm just telling you, I was into your kooky little Jew weirdness, and you got this little fucking bitch boy that tries to look like Kermit the Frog. Wait, listen to me. I already know this little Jew fucking effeminate bitch has nothing on me.
I got everything
man,
on
everybody
you.
Everybody knows that. So, you know what? Don't you fucking kiss my ass like a couple of nights ago, 3 hours talking. The night before, another 3.5 hours talking.
You spent 3 hours talking to this man.
Look at my channel, Virtuous Alley Spartan.
What do you think he's me?
Look at all the shit that I'm going to be posting. Look at everything I've already recorded with her admitting shit with me. Don't ever kiss my ass again. Don't ever, ever kiss my ass again. I made your channel. You always kiss my ass. You say, get EB.
No?
Last night you told... Please get
so I guess when you're
Spaniard.
Feeling down.
And then now you're fucking
yeah.
this guy, and you're telling me you're with me? You're telling me you're with me? You're a dirty fucking Jew pig. You don't deserve a man like me. I'm a way more spiritual compass. I don't know why the fuck that I was manipulated by a piece of shit by you. But you know what? You can help me out. I can put my dick in your mouth, and we can do some little weird shit with this little effeminate Jew. He could fuck you, and I can put my dick in your mouth when you come back to L.A. And, that's the only way you're going to be my friend again. And we're going to collaborate.
That's the only
I know
way.
You're going to be kissing my
That's
ass
the
very
only
soon
way.
After what I do. Hey, shut the fuck up, you little fucking placating asshole. Shut the fuck up. You'll never be a man like me, a true Spartan. Bye, Jew, you dirty bitches.
But there's no other way for her to earn back his respect.
Don't listen
Spinning
to
sent
$5.
Dude,
thank you, Spinning. Oh, thank you, Spinning. One second. I have a great song. I wrote this for Spartan.
Oh, you wrote it?
Thank
song?
You, Spinning.
Is this your new song?
This is my new song.
Oh, my God.
This is my new song.
I used to be in love with him, but now my love is fading. He always sends me messages and always calls me baby. He makes friends with my friends, but then is always debating. I used to be in love with him.
Virtue is Spartan on my mind. Virtue is Spartan on my mind.
Anonymous sent $10.
Do you miss Kermit a lot?
$10?
I'm sorry that your dog passed away, sweetheart.
Oh, yeah.
You're welcome. Why were you so attached to the dog?
Oh, my first dog, yeah.
Oh. Aw. Oh, he was a little baby?
He recorded it.
She was 14. She passed. thought
you
spent a lot longer than that.
Yeah, I know how it is. Like, you get attached to them, you think they're gonna live forever. But yeah, it's just nature took its course, sweetheart. But it may be a long life. Poor dog. I love you.
Yeah, I kind of knew it was going to be dying soon because I prayed for, like, this one night she was really doing bad, and I prayed for 3 more months with her, and I got 3 more months. It was weird.
Really? Interesting. Yeah, like, interesting. Go ahead, I'm sorry, sweetheart.
And then, after I prayed for the 3 more months, COVID happened.
Oh, this is around COVID time. Interesting.
Yeah, and then they made me work from home.
Yeah.
So the last 3 months I had with her, I was working from home.
Oh. So you got very intimate with her.
Yeah, like, so she was sitting on my lap every day.
Oh, sweetheart, I'm sorry. I had the same situation happened with my ex-girlfriend right before we broke up. When I was in, she had a cat. She had a lot of years, like you. Maybe 13 or something years. And it was dying. It was going through the same thing where it was like going in convulsions. She'd have to feed it. She'd have to clean feces. And she's just so in love with the cat. She's like crying every day. And then like she had a lady come, like a nurse.
Really?
And she gave it a shot to kill it. She was, it was like kind of the same situation where she's like praying for it.
Yeah, not really.
Wow. I'm sorry to laugh. I started laughing. I started laughing one time. I didn't mean to laugh. She was just so cute. Like, she was like crying,
wait,
like touching his head. It was going to convulsions.
Wait, what?
The cat was going to convulsions. It was like, it was.
Wait,
go on the bed when we were asleep in the morning, and it would like kind of rub her or me, like it just like his paw real slow.
That is weird that you're laughing.
I'm sorry. It was just so beautiful. The cat, he just barely, he like had a human personality. That's why I think she loved him so much, right? And it was like a strong masculine cat. She's all weird. It's like a little Leonardo DiCaprio.
Like Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yeah, kind of Leonardo DiCaprio. And then you went to and I started laughing. I couldn't help it. I love the cat. I was like, what the fuck is wrong with me? It was just because I was drinking like a whole lot that time. And I was just drunk that day, and she would get mad. I think that's what ruined the relationship, because I started drinking a lot. But she fucking I remember I was like, what the fuck? I'm like loving the cat. I'm almost ready to cry because of the way the cat looks, and it's so beautiful cat. And it's trying hard to live. And I'm actually witnessing this. I bring my cat too to live with us. His name was Cubby. My cat was the strongest cat. He could have been in the movie star. But anyways, I don't want to talk about my cat right now, but I got my cat a little baby. I rescued him from a shelter. They found him on LA Street. At the LA but anyways, yeah, I took my cat there. Yeah, her cat was dying. And I don't know why I just started laughing one time when he was shaking on the fucking bed. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with me? What the fuck? And I couldn't hold it. I was trying to hold it in because I didn't want her to like freak out. Like, this guy's a...
Okay, so that was a call that I didn't know was being recorded. So Virtuous Spartan.
It's a long call.
Yeah, too. Virtuous Spartan would like call me a lot, especially at night, like late at night. And a lot of times I was sleeping, but sometimes I did answer. And I, you know, when I'm not doing IRL, I'm pretty bored.
Right.
That's the truth. You know, IRL is like all I'm doing right now. So if I'm not doing it every day, I'm kind of bored. I'm just in my apartment thinking of ideas. And so, yeah, I talked to Virtuous Spartan. I liked his voice. He has a cool voice. And his original picture was really cute. And that's it. I don't know, guys. You know, I don't have much. Oh, somebody. Hello? Hello? How can I help you?
Thanks for signing.
Oh, never mind. yeah, so, I mean, I did get attached to him. He's good at, he's a good conversationalist. He keeps the conversation going.
Yeah.
He's very, like, emotionally present. He's manipulative. He's very good with women. Let me just say that. I would say if he talked to any woman, they would like him. Because women, okay, if you look at...
But he says the things that are, like...
No, I know he says some bad things, very bad things. But one more thing I want to say is there's an article that actually backs up my theory. Yes, how can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to just address the Virtuous Spartan. It was very, very sad and emotionally draining to hear about his poor cat. You know, it's sad that Spartan's cat died. But, you know, that cat died with Spartan's cock.
All right. Okay, so here. Okay, so there's an article I'd like to read you guys that I looked up earlier. Megan Fox told...
It says, like, keep talking to guys and say they're going to kill you.
Machine Gun Kelly. Hold on one second. Okay, so Machine Gun Kelly, Megan Fox, dangerous relationships. Hold on. So
this is what we've been harping on, is that there's something weird that draws you to Spartan that's sort of...
Yes.
Off.
Okay, so I was thinking about this a lot, and I Googled it several times, and that guy, I think his name is Jordan Peterson... had a video, and I watched the video, and it was like all about Spartan. It was crazy.
Really?
Okay, so this video that I saw, Jordan Peterson was talking about why women like dangerous men.
Yeah.
Because women don't really like the safe men.
How?
They like to be like put on edge a little bit, and like unsure, and like questioning. And I think women actually...
You actually kind of like some of that stuff?
Wait, let me just see what she says. I was just reading an article about Megan Fox and Machine Gun Kelly, and she's talking about how she's attracted to, like, dangerous men. Have you heard anything about that? Do you agree with that at all? Are you attracted?
The bad boy.
So, I'm trying to explain to my friend Eric and the people that are watching on my blog why I'm, like, attracted to this guy, Virtuous Spartan, and I think it's because women like a sense of danger and, like, being unsure. What else do you think it is? Okay.
I think it's the desire to tame someone.
The desire to tame someone. Why is that? Why can't we just have someone as they are?
I'm going
to
eat my lunch with you guys.
Okay. Thank you. That's so nice. Thank you. Yeah, because I like to make my blog about my relationships a lot. And so I was just and I have this caller, this guy.
Who's this super toxic individual.
Yeah, this guy is super toxic.
He's so incredibly toxic. But he does have some kind of sweet, gentle sides. But then he'll just go off.
Have 1 minute. I work out there, but keep talking.
But Elisa has been like cozying up with this person for hours and hours on end.
He has a very sexy voice.
Outside of the show. And we're all really shocked.
Okay, I'll show you a picture of him.
Because one moment she's like going to get the cops because he's threatening to kill her.
Oh, that's different.
And then the next minute she's spending 3 hours listening to him about this cat.
Well, okay, so here. So the first thing that I saw about is this picture. Can I just show you this picture? You think he's cute?
I can't really see him. I mean, that says a lot. He's. I mean, look at the three levels of cover. He has the hoodie, the baseball cap, and the big glasses. It's hard to see.
Yeah, I know. But just based on that.
That says a lot.
Oh, you think he's like hiding something?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Yeah, okay, so I was attracted to that picture.
Yeah, I mean, it's sexy. It's
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank God.
All right, the verdict is that it's sexy. Okay, I knew it.
I knew I'm like not completely like out of my mind. Everybody's trying to make
sexy.
Me think.
He's very
like,
sexy.
Thank you. He's very sexy. Do you hear that, everybody? Okay, so I knew I was not out of my mind, and everybody's trying to make me think that I'm so crazy for talking to this guy. So that's his picture, and then he's very good with writing. So he writes. He's a beautiful writer. He is. And he's a fan of this network that I'm on. It's called IP2. And there's streamers, people that do live streaming and blogs. And he's a fan of a lot of the same people that I'm a fan of. And I see when he, like, writes in their chat, the things that he writes stand out so much. And they're very, like, prolific. And I'm like, wow, this guy is very educated. So not only is he cute, but he's educated. And he's very, like, I don't know, just the way he writes, it got me. I don't know. I like when people are good writers. And then he called into my show, and his call created a lot of waves. So everybody, like, either hated him or loved him.
Everybody either hates or loves him.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Everybody either hates or loves him. So it's that picture. But then he sent a bunch of other pictures that were not good, that I didn't like. Because he's very unkempt. Mm. Like, he keeps his hair very long. It looks like he hasn't had a haircut in, like, years. I don't like that. And his beard, he's a long beard. Don't like that. But the original...
But he was clean shaven.
I know, he was clean shaven. Exactly. So when I saw the clean shaven, I was super attracted to him. Like a 10 out of 10. But then when he showed the pictures of him with long hair, I wasn't attracted to him.
Do you have pictures?
Yeah, I could show you the other pictures. Yeah. Hold on. These are not good pictures. Hold on.
So you have a relationship blog.
Yeah, and a travel blog. So we're going to Arizona. I'm going to Palm Beach. I'm going to... I like to travel a lot with it, and I also it's a relationship blog too. I have a bunch of, like, specialties, dating, but I'm not good at dating. That's the funny. I like talking about it. It's like my favorite topic is relationship.
She's pretty good at dating.
She'll go out
on dates with people, you know, that are really interesting. You know,
the dates
always explode in her face.
How
you know?
Do you find your date?
But that's what keeps.
And this is his other picture that I don't like. Isn't that cute on that?
Do you know who he reminds me of, the concept?
Who?
I think his name's Ezra Miller. Do you know the actor Ezra Miller, who is on Marvel? And he's, like, losing his mind.
Oh, yeah.
He's been arrested. Like, he's really, really good looking.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I just looked him up. I wasn't familiar with him. But, yeah, he has, like, a vampire look. I don't like that look. I like a clean-shaven look. I like a guy that's, like, you know, a bad boy, but you can also take him into the office. We used to work in finance together, and I like a guy that could fit into that kind of environment.
That you can have great sex with.
Yeah, but yeah. The kind of guy you have great sex with is this kind of bad
boy. I know.
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, my God. Are you a therapist?
No.
Oh, my God. You seem like you... What do you do?
I work at this library.
Oh, it's a library? Oh, cool. That's a cool library.
So, how do you meet guys for your dates? I mean, how do you meet... online or
so I meet them through my show. So, like, Eric, how I dated him is I used to work in finance, and we were kind of like partners there. We did a lot of deals together. We worked at a gold company together, and we did deals, and we were like partners. It was very fun, and we used to go to lunch every day.
It was really fun.
Yeah.
But then I went kind of loopy for a little while there.
Yeah.
And I left.
He actually got brought out in a straitjacket, Eric. Right?
No, but I did call the cops. I thought they were trying to kill me or something.
Yeah,
like that.
He like went crazy there. Like, it was a very intense.
There was a lot of stress.
Yeah, it was
it
so
all
much stress.
Mounted at one point. It just kind of crushed me.
Did you get a diagnosis by any chance?
Yeah, bipolar.
Yeah.
So.
I'm bipolar too, I think.
Yeah, I think in a lot of ways we all are.
I mean, I'm very up and down. I'm depressed a lot, but I'm happy today because I'm with Eric and we're collaborating. So it depends on what I'm doing.
I think we're both bipolar, so we get along with each other.
Yeah, he's actually dating my friend now, Elaine.
Yeah, I've been dating Elaine.
He's dating Elaine. Yeah, it's pretty wild.
That's really nice.
Elaine is the best thing that's ever happened to me in my whole life.
Really?
Yeah.
Elaine?
Yeah.
Why? Are you introducing Elaine to him?
Elaine is
very level, and she really listens. She really cares, you know, in a way that no other woman I've ever really dated I can talk to for hours and hours and hours on end every day.
Well, she probably really is in love with you, Eric.
Well, I know that.
Yeah, she definitely is. Yeah, my friend Elaine. So this is interesting about Elaine. Can I tell her, like, some details? Okay, so Elaine is my very good friend. She lives down the street from here. And she used to be my partner with my blog. And we used to do this together, like, every day. We traveled. We were in, like, Clearwater, Florida. We were great partners. She had a lot of fans, right? And she's also, how do I say it? Is this a necessary detail? I don't know if it is or not. But she's like, you know, like double his age at least, you know?
She's a cougar.
Yeah, she's a cougar. So she's like...
We're in total cougar
town. Yeah. So don't you love that? I love that too.
Yeah.
I love it.
Since it's out, how old are you and how old is she?
She's like 60 something and I'm 30 something.
So we're talking about a 30 year age.
Yeah, 30 year age difference. Like double my age.
I think that's fabulous.
You love that? I love that too. Oh my God, you're so cool. I love that too. I love it. I love the way the tables have turned. I'm so sick of, like, you know, seeing like all the old guys with like the 18 year old girls.
Well, look at Cher. Cher's a good example.
Cher? Mm-hmm. Wait, who's Cher dating?
Cher's dating, there's a 40 year age difference. If you look up Cher.
Oh, Cher boyfriend? Let me look that up.
C-H-E-R.
Cher.
I think Madonna has a boyfriend. Oh, really,
her boyfriends are like 20 years old.
Well,
yeah.
Madonna's not fair. I mean, she's like something else. She's not a cougar, she's something else.
Well, okay. Here's Cher's boyfriend. Oh my God.
It's a 40-year age difference.
Wow. Yeah, I'm all for it. I'm all for it as well. I love it. I mean, I'm happy about it. It's just like an interesting situation. You know, I used to be engaged to Eric. Now he's dating my friend. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to include her because we're going to be like traveling together, working together. So I want her to be there. It's just very like weird situation. But
do you guys make money at this?
Yes.
Yeah. People donate songs and she makes like $5 here, $10 here.
So it equates to like around $100 an hour. But you like, and some people do it for 24 hours. A guy, Ice Poseidon, does it for 24 hours in Tokyo. He's doing it. He made $80,000 this month.
Oh my God.
Yep.
That's unbelievable.
But, because
when you tune into his live streams, he's just literally sleeping in bed.
Yeah, he's doing nothing. So Ice Poseidon is the biggest at this, what I'm doing right now. I'm on the same like website as him. So it's IRL, which is in real life. So basically you're showing your life. And he's traveling Tokyo right now, meeting up with fans. So that's something that I do a lot. I meet up with fans and basically just tour their city. And yeah, it's around like $100 an hour. That guy, he has like 1 million subscribers. So for him, it equates to like $80,000 a month. But that's like, and I only have like about 10,000 subscribers. But if I had 100,000 subscribers, it would be like incredible money.
10,000, how much money?
So like 100 an hour. So if you worked like 12 hours, that'd be 1,200 a day. I do not work 12 hours.
It'd be exhausting.
It would be exhausting. But if I triple my channel, I'll make, you know, 300 an hour probably. You know, so it's just building and growing, and I think it's great, and I think everybody should do it because it's a really awesome way to connect with people. Like for instance, a lot of my
I have to go.
I
work at the library.
Oh, okay.
But you have the right personality.
Oh, thank you. Thank you
doesn't
so much.
She?
Thank
I mean,
you.
She's got star power to the nines.
Thank you.
Doesn't she?
You need a certain type of personality. So do you want my advice on this guy?
Yes.
Okay. My advice is have sex with him.
Oh.
And then, yeah, just a friends with benefit. Don't have
but
the friends.
But he might cut her head off. I mean, he's literally.
Well, I hope drained. That he doesn't do that. Yeah.
No, but I wouldn't be in a relationship with him.
Yeah, yeah, thank you. That's good. You're so cool. Are you on Instagram or anything?
No,
you're not on anything?
I'm not on social media.
Oh.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, that's okay. I just think you're so cool. Like,
well, thank you.
Yeah,
I really appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You keep having fun at what you're doing.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Have
you
a
so
great
much.
Day.
What's
Maybe
your,
we can visit
name?
You sometime.
I'm
Dawn, thank you so much.
And your name?
Eric.
Alisa.
And Alisa.
So nice to meet you.
So nice to meet you.
Fun. Okay, bye.
You're
guys.
So sweet.
So much.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you. Wow,
but
she's so nice, right?
That's so great.
Oh. All right.
So she says you should actually have sex with him.
I know. I did hear that. Yeah. I took it in.
Crazy.
All right. I'm sorry you guys are bored. I'm sorry. That was IRL, wasn't it? We were talking to someone.
Well, you had sex
with... They want IRL, but they don't really want
you
it.
You had sex with Gonzo.
Yeah, I did.
And you said it was the best sex in your whole
life.
It
was pretty good. It was pretty good. You know why? Because it's the same kind of thing. It's the same kind of thing where... I didn't explain it right. I don't think I explained it right. Basically, Spartan has a good voice. He's intelligent. I don't care what anybody says. He's intelligent. He speaks well. He creates a story. He's good with women. I was going to tell you guys about this article that I read about Megan Fox. Let me do that. Because I was curious. Actually, this just like popped up on my feed. Wait, Megan Fox, Machine Gun Kelly, bad relationship. Oh. So some women, and I want to include myself in this, even though I wish I didn't, you know, I wish I wasn't like this. You think I'm happy I'm like this? You think I'm fucking happy? I'm not.
We love
I'm,
that you like
I,
this,
I,
though.
I wish I could date, like, you know,
we love you
a regular
like this,
guy.
Lisa.
Thank you, thank you. Okay, yes, how can I help you? Hello?
Okay, so, first of all, Ice doesn't make 80K a month.
I thought he did. I'm sorry.
That's not true.
Okay.
That's number one. Number two,
He only streams for like 2 months.
No, no, I know. I didn't explain it right, but I'm just saying I was trying to explain to her the possibilities. The possibilities are high. They're endless possibilities. I think Ice could make more than that. I think everybody that's watching should do this because it's fun.
Okay, that's good, but at least get the facts straight.
All right, maybe I didn't have my facts straight.
Lies out there.
I'm not lying. I really thought that. If you really think something, it's not a lie.
Yeah. She truly believes
that. I truly believe that he makes a lot of money doing this and that a lot of people do, and I think I do too. I just haven't streamed. If I streamed every day, I'd be very financially comfortable. But I don't have anybody to stream with! What?
Okay. I like the optimism.
Did you hear what I said?
Summer Page 9 sent $3. Is this armor? Are the rock rumors true?
What? What rumors? Wait, what rumors, Summer? Okay. Type in the chat. Yeah, it's not going to help.
So, the second thing is you're glorifying this Spartan guy. And you're making it... You're making him like a role model for dating.
A role model?
Role model.
Okay, women like bad boys. The librarian just said that. Okay? Are you going to argue with her? You think she's lying? You want me to go up to 20 women right now?
I'm not arguing with anybody. I just want you to know that you're setting a really bad role model for Chet. So now everybody that's listening is going to be like, oh, you know what? I'm going to talk like that to a girl.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. All right. Okay. All right. All right. All right.
Tell her that he's going to egg her.
Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. So don't.
Don't egg her.
Okay. All right. All right. All right. You have a point, Carl. All right.
Listen up. I'm going to kill you tonight. You're going to get off that?
It doesn't sound as good when you say it. I'm sorry. It doesn't sound
as good. Unless it is convincing.
So don't make it a role model for Chet.
All right. All right. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. All right. Okay. All right. All right. Thank you. That was a good. I'm sorry. Okay. All right.
So don't make it a role model for Chet.
Pamela Anderson sent $3. Pamela Anderson's new documentary on Netflix. She talks about needing that bad boy, being attracted to that exciting energy to be happy.
Thank you, audience. Thank you. Thank God. Somebody, because I knew I wasn't crazy. A lot of people try to make me think that I'm crazy.
You're not crazy.
I know I'm not. Well, I know that. But anyway, according to Pamela Anderson, that's what she's attracted to. She has been
like the Tommy Lee.
He's very bad. Megan Fox. There's a brand new article this week. Megan Fox and Machine Gun Kelly have been criticized for their choice of relationships, romanticizing a toxic relationship. That's what they do. That's what Megan Kelly. And Megan Fox is, I want to say, in the top 1% looks. You cannot be better looking than her. It's impossible. And Pamela Anderson too.
I don't know. This one right here is pretty up there.
Thank you, Eric. That's very nice. But
Megan Fox, Elisa Jordan. All Megan
right.
Fox.
All right. I mean, I'm probably funnier. It's true. I mean,
Jennifer Aniston, Elisa Jordan.
I don't even think Jennifer Aniston's that cute. But okay.
Elisa Jordan, Elaine.
Elaine better than me? Okay. All right. That's fine. That's your girl, so that's fine. How's that going? Did you guys do it? No. No. Okay. Let me know. All right. Pamela Anderson. Megan Fox, the top good-looking people always go for bad boys. That's just the way it is. And I'm telling you guys, that is just how it goes, right? Okay, let's ask this one.
Yeah.
Bad boys, good, right? Yeah. Everybody agrees. You guys, it's just true. It's the truth. Fox posted a series of pictures of her and Kelly dressed as Pamela Anderson, Tommy Lee. See, they idolized.
But you could get really hurt by somebody like this if you were.
You
like,
think so?
Yes.
I could get hurt by anyone.
No, I mean like he could snap on you.
You think he could snap?
Yeah, because he does snap on you on the phone.
Yeah.
And then he's like trying to get the address of Billy John so that he can go.
Oh yeah, yeah.
His
yeah.
legs in. I swear to God, if you give me a. I'll give you money. I'll give you $200 for it, Billy John.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was bad. That was very bad. Okay, like, since the dawn of social media.
You think he's joking, but he's not.
You don't think he's joking?
No.
You threatened to kill me too, Eric.
Do you think I was joking?
I don't know. You probably wanted to at the time.
At the time, I was freaking a loony.
I know, but you did threaten to kill me, and you weren't doing well at the time, so, and look at us now.
Well, now I'm on meds.
What meds are you on?
Abilify.
All right, good. Okay, since the dawn of social media, celebrities have taken over our feeds with over-the-top displays of affection. But that behavior is turning increasingly dark. Are we being swept up in their love hurricane and turning a blind eye to some serious red flags? What's going on with Hollywood couples at the moment? Okay. What they're saying is things are turning dark. The public is obviously fascinated with these types of relationships, as their engagement videos have jointly racked up in almost 45 million views on Instagram. This is Megan Fox. And despite pleading for his estranged wife, Kim Kardashian, to run back to me during a performance, Kanye West has thrown himself into a new relationship, another toxic one. So this is like not just me, you guys. Don't act like I'm different.
No.
I'm not different. You've got needs. I'm the same.
Just like any other woman, you've got needs.
Yeah, you're a bad boy. That's why Elaine likes you. Newsflash. The reason why Elaine, I'm saying it right now, the reason why Elaine likes this guy...
Because I blew up on Andy and I was out of my mind for a while.
You're very volatile.
I was That's totally right. volatile for a while, and now that she's tamed me.
That's right.
You know.
And trust me, she loves this whole thing that I'm trying to get her to stream and you're here. She's going nuts. She loves it.
Of course.
Yeah. So I'm not different. That's the way everybody is. So. All right. But I'm not going to meet up with Spartan just because, you know, I am scared of him, so.
I would.
But he did write that song. I don't know.
That's a great song.
It's such a good song.
I love that song.
I want to sing it again. Just sing it again.
Yeah.
Usually women grow out of this? No. I'm gonna say, chat, that is not true. Women do not grow out of this because my grandma, my last conversation that I had with one of my grandmas was that she had a crush on a guy at church that was married and was winking at her. So no, she was in her 80s at that point. You do not grow out of it. All right, I'm just going to replay this dono because I would like to sing this song.
Is that your new song?
It's a song that I sang before, but I think people will understand it more.
Spin and sent $5.
And then we'll do some IRL because I feel bad that we haven't done that much.
Well, that woman counts as...
That woman, they didn't like that, though.
Oh, they didn't like that?
I don't know why they... I know.
I guess we need, like, crazy...
I used to be in love with him, but now my love is fading. He always sends me messages and always calls me baby. He makes friends with my friends, but then it's a waste of baby. I used to be in love with him, but you were spying on my mind.
Drop you off at the lane. We could interview five.
Such a beautiful voice.
I have a beautiful voice. All right, thank you.
Get the voice.
Thank you. Okay, so we have a couple choices right now. What we can do? I was thinking we could interview five. But I feel bad because I took you from her, right?
Yeah, but we're having so much fun.
We're having so much fun, but like I feel like I should deliver you back to Elaine.
At some point.
What should I do? I don't know what to do. I can't take Eric all day from Elaine. Right? What do you guys think I should do?
I think we should keep having fun.
You think we should keep having fun?
Yeah.
Really?
Because I'll be in town for...
How long? Till Sunday?
Till Sunday.
So here's my plans. I'm going to tell you my plans. You tell me your plans, okay? So my plan today... What?
Interruption. I have no plans.
You don't have any plans?
I don't have any plans.
But what does Elaine want to do with you?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
You don't know what she wants to do?
I don't know. Like, go see a movie.
Oh, like, you like see a movie? Like normal stuff?
Yeah, just normal stuff. Normal.
All right.
Stuff.
All right.
But you have plans to go to...
Yeah, so I'm going to Long Beach tomorrow. I mean, I could let you be with Elaine tomorrow unless you want to go to Long Beach with me. But, like, I feel bad taking you to Long Beach, taking you to Newport Beach. That's going to last the whole day.
But also, we got to consider Moss's feelings.
Yeah, okay, let me call Moss.
Because Moss...
But we don't even know if Elaine would be willing to go. Would Elaine be willing to go with you and me and Moss as a double date?
Not if we're streaming.
Not if we're streaming. Got it. Damn it. So complicated. Everything's so complicated. Can't she just enjoy her fame? Can't she just enjoy it? All right. No. All right.
So you want to, do you want to go walk around?
Yeah, yeah. Let's, we'll end soon, but I think we should just like maybe interview a couple people. It's just like, it's so dead over here. It's like very, I don't like LA anymore, by the way.
Oh, really?
I think I'm going to move to Florida. Yeah.
Oh, no.
It's like more happening over there, I think. I need to get a car. If I had a car, it'd be different.
Yeah, get a car.
I should just get a car.
You could just buy a car tonight.
Like, I saw a car for like $1,200.
You just buy it.
And it was a little Mini Cooper. I was like, I should just buy that.
Yeah, you should just buy that.
All right. Moss, I'm afraid to call Moss. And also, if I called Moss, what would I tell him? I don't have Elaine for, like, and I'm not going to take Eric away from Elaine for like 12 hours. I can't do that. Because tomorrow's going to be like a 12. So Moss is picking me up at 12 noon tomorrow. We're driving to Long Beach. I'm going to stream the whole way in the car. And when we get to Long Beach, we're going to go into this like coin collection thing. It might be boring. So I might have to rely on like callers and stuff.
That sounds like so much fun.
You think so?
Yeah.
You would like that?
Yeah, that sounds like so much fun.
Anonymous sent $5.
But I don't know if Moss would.
Yes. Talking about any chance to get
in a daze with that song. It was so gorgeous. Oh, is there somebody on the phone? Yes, how can I help you?
Okay, so you didn't let me finish number three, okay? So number three is, let's talk about this Eric guy.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, what about me?
And let's talk about how better he is than that stupid Moss guy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? I think Chet enjoys Eric's femininity, and I think the camera loves him.
I guess I am a little bit like, effeminate.
But, like, wait, you guys are a better duo than that Moss guy. So just so you know.
All right. I've been friends with Eric for, like, many years, so, and I only know Moss very recently through Andy, so, I mean, Eric is staying in my life no matter what.
Oh, yeah.
So,
yeah. So if he's willing to stay with you the whole day, let him stay with you.
Eric? Don't but like the thing is, Elaine, okay, so I hear you, Carl, but Elaine is, you know, they orchestrated them flying in at the same time. He's staying with her. I think, like, it's wrong for me to take Eric for the whole day.
The guy loves your energy. Just let him be. The camera is already loves him. So don't take that away from you know, the whole show.
Yeah, you know? I hear you. I mean,
yeah.
I wish Eric lived here. I'd hang out with him every day. I was so sad, honestly.
Okay.
I've had nobody.
Okay, so take advantage of this opportunity. He's there, so enjoy him and let Chet enjoy him too.
Oh, that's very kind.
That's really nice.
That's really nice.
Yeah,
you know?
That's really, really
yeah.
nice.
But what you're used to doing is you're used to, you know, stream with Moss. And even though you know Chet hates Moss, you were like, oh, Moss is staying. I'm gonna hang out with Moss the whole day and making Chet suffer. That's not the right way.
I don't want Chet to suffer. That is not my intention.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, just so you know, I was suffering when I was watching.
You were suffering?
Moss. Like, yes, bleeding. I was literally bleeding.
You were bleeding when Moss was on? You were bleeding?
Yes.
From where?
Yes. That's facts.
Where were you bleeding
Moss
from?
Moss is just the worst.
Yeah, where were you bleeding from?
What area, sir?
Sir, what area of your body were you bleeding from?
Did you hear that question?
I mean, my brain.
Your
my
brain?
My brain was bleeding. Like, just watching Moss on camera. Like, the guy is not, like, good material for a stream at all.
The blood was coming out of your head during Moss's segments?
Yes, like nose bleeding, brain bleeding, everything. Eyes, everything.
Oh no. That's very bad. That's not good.
By the way, he's very unattractive for a male. Just so you know, very unattractive.
What about him? Is that a child? Well, hey,
no,
fine.
You got low standards, Elisa. We all know that.
Well,
trust me, we do.
We all.
But you got the lowest standards of any female I've ever watched or met. So it's okay. But just so you know, like, this Eric guy, keep him. Take advantage.
Like, I was bleeding from his brain.
Bleeding from his
that's
brain
really,
watching
that's
Moss. That's how
bad,
terrible.
That's how bad it was.
It was watching.
That's
yeah, it
not
was.
Good.
It was pretty terrible.
That was bad. You thought it was bad?
Well, I like everything that you do. You know, honestly, whatever you do, I eat it up. You know.
Yeah.
Because you're my best friend, and
Anonymous sent $5.
Whatever it comes together. You know?
Swing, swing.
Anonymous sent $5. Moss is like a number two pencil, and why does Eric look like Sherwin?
I don't know who Sherwin is.
We need Elaine really fast. And Spartan go dive into an empty and ground pool.
Listen, life is not easy.
Calling it like it is.
It's hard
to hit the nail on the head like
five times.
It's hard
to find the perfect person. Oh, I do feel like we should call Elaine again.
We should?
Yeah, so like... You don't know
she
what
she probably needs like a nap anyway.
Oh, you think she needs a nap?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah, because she didn't get a lot of sleep.
Alright. Alright, so I'm trying to call Elaine and involve Elaine and things just so I have some proof. See, this is a good thing about these live streams. They're proof. Like you can't say that I didn't try.
Oh yeah.
I've tried. Oh, maybe that's her. Is that her? Who's that?
I don't know. I think it's for like a job interview. Hello?
All right, so I have tried several times to get Elaine involved. I even tried to give Eric back to Elaine. I've tried it all, okay? So you saw that I put in good effort. IRL customer service, how can I help you?
Oh my gosh, she's still talking to this guy.
Yeah, so I was interested in your little song when you said, the Virtuous song.
Yeah.
Spartan song.
Yeah.
Are you baiting? Wait, shut the fuck up. Just shut up, you fucking ugly fucking soul bitch. You don't
Virtuous
have no
Spartan,
soul.
I'm gonna stop answering your calls.
Wait, just shut the fuck up. Let me talk. If you're a brave woman and you wanna let me get a freedom of speech, you don't have any kind of threatened feelings, shut the fuck up. Let me express myself.
See, I don't think you deserve to be talked to.
Okay. I don't.
Andy would talk to you like
shut
this.
Shut the little Jew bitch
that.
Is fucking threatened by me too. Shut the fuck up,
and
too,
I know
you
you're
faggot.
Be a nice Spartan.
Listen to me. You baiting? Baiting? I thought he was going to be baiting. So you know, all these hours, copious amounts of hours that I'm going to be showing very soon on the Discord and my YouTube, all the sexual shit too. That's all baiting?
He's threatening to release sexual stuff.
Wait. When you're talking like
you
a little girl?
Sexual stuff
on her? Wait. When you hear the subtlety of the true levels of non-contrived feelings when you're talking like a little girl and you're saying, and you're... To bring all that on to the fucking thing? You want me to do it now? I've been bringing all that on. You want to keep it for some reason. I know you're in love with me. And all these other motherfuckers don't realize that little baiting verse, it don't mean shit. Because I've been proving everything you've been saying wrong about
me. Are you
in
love with him?
I've been proving all of it.
I don't
so
know.
You want to still say that you're baiting? Okay,
like
so you're still saying... So, okay. So on top of that, you're going to tell me that this is all a game? You really baited me? So this wasn't love?
I said you're always debating.
He's extremely abusive.
You know what, motherfucker? You better shut the fuck up, because I'll break your face.
All right, stop. I'm hanging up, Spartan. Okay, no more Spartan. It's addictive talking to him. I don't know why, Eric. It's addictive talking to him.
I one time had a roommate
who's
met a woman through Xbox Live.
Xbox Live?
Yeah, and...
What?
The girl he met brought two daughters with them.
Yeah?
But her mother was in an abusive relationship with her father, you know?
Yeah.
And her father killed her mother.
What?
Yeah. Like, abuse can, like... It can really drive a person crazy.
All right, so maybe I just won't talk to him anymore. It's hard because I was talking to him a lot, and he...
See, because I would hate for you to, like, genuinely, you know... get it on with this person and then he's literally abusing.
Well, I was saying that he should stream with someone else so I could watch him and see what he's like. I'm trying to get him to be nice to me. He can't. He's very like, I don't know, but I am drunk. You know, I called the therapist to talk about
it. You called the therapist?
I called the therapist.
Good.
Yeah. I said.
Good for you.
I did call, yeah.
That is really good for
you. Yeah, and
how did that go?
Well, I was saying that I mean, my last few people that I liked have not been good.
Yeah.
You know? My last few people have been very bad.
Yeah.
So.
They've been really mean to you.
Andy wasn't that great.
Yeah, Andy was a real jerk to you.
Yeah.
at times, you know?
Yeah.
And that's what I mean, you know, Andy sort of maybe started that trend of being a real
jerk. But
Andy,
I wasn't really, like, attracted to at all. I wasn't sexually attracted to him, no.
Oh,
this
come
guy,
on.
I
yes,
am.
You were.
No, I wasn't. I would say it. I'm honest. I would say it. I was never
there
attracted.
Were so many times you put on your high heels for Andy.
No, I tried once. It didn't even work.
That's because Andy's gay.
I know.
He's totally
no,
gay.
Andy, there's nothing sexual with him. But this guy, I'm very attracted to. I don't know why. I know why. It's there's stats, Eric. It says it. There's scientific articles that talk about why you like people like this. Why? You know, and it's,
you know, and the funny thing is, as an audience, you know, hearing you being talked to like that by an ignoramus, you know, pardon my French, you know, is sort of entertaining, you know? Because it's like, who could get away with saying that he's going to bleep you in your behind?
I hope he stops talking like that. I hope he stops. All right,
so as a fan, you know, it's kind of interesting, but...
Yeah. No, I know it's... I mean, Eric...
But as a friend...
You threatened to kill me so many times, remember?
Am I seeing a therapist now? Yes.
Yes, you are. So maybe Virtuous Spartan can see a therapist, and then
and
he
a
can
therapist can really stop you and kind of get in.
Thank you, Devin. Thank you, everybody. Thanks for the support. We're just gonna interview a couple people, then we're gonna end.
Okay.
I think we've done enough. We did a lot today. Oh, and also it's about I don't have much battery left, so let's find somebody really fast to interview, and then we'll end. But I feel like this was a really strong stream. I wish I could get Elaine on the stream. Can you work on it? Yeah, I guess no.
I'll work on it, you know, but...
All right.
Is it going to happen within the next 4 days? Probably not.
Probably not. Wow.
You know.
All right, you want to interview this person? He looks friendly.
Which person?
Huh? That?
I think he's on the phone.
No. Terrible stream? Really? You know, I do miss my friend Leaf being in the chat, but...
Yeah.
He has not been in the chat today.
So what happened to Leaf?
Leaf got upset because the Virtuous Spartan.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Leaf got upset. It happens. It happens every 6 months. Leaf gets upset about something.
Okay.
Yeah. Thanks, Sydney Cat. You know, Leaf was like my number one supporter. Oh. I have a lot of great supporters. There's no doubt about that. There's a lot of great people that support my streams and are so nice to me. And the IP2 people and the Kermit and Friends people. Who's this? IRL, how can I help you?
Yeah, Lisa. Who's this gentleman you guys are? Eric?
Eric. Yeah, it's my friend Eric.
How's it going?
Can I ask him the million-dollar question?
Yeah, sure. Here he is. Here.
Have I had sex with Elaine?
Yeah, did you get to pound that pussy good, bro? Was it good?
No, not yet, but I think we're working on it. We're making progress.
Yeah, she's a good-looking young lady. I think she...
Wait, who are you guys talking about right now?
Elaine is a super good-looking young lady. I mean, she's freaking quality.
Take her to pound town, buddy.
Yes. High fives all the way.
All right, brother.
Okay, brother.
Ah, that's a nice call. I wonder if Elaine's watching right now. I wish Elaine would call in. She's not going to call in. Very sad.
There's nothing to really do here.
There's nothing to do. We just gotta find one person, because I don't like, you know, saying I'm gonna do IRL and not doing it, because people, like, you know, they think
we
I'm lying.
That one person over there.
What about somebody over here? Oh, this is so nice over here. Wow.
You can ask him if we can interview him. It's working out.
How about, like, life advice from this guy?
Yeah, you could ask him about Virtuous Spartan.
You could ask him about Elaine.
Oh.
Are you confident about that?
I don't know.
Are you confident about the relationship?
I think we should ask him about Spark.
Go ahead, Eric. Oh, wait, somebody's calling me.
Alright. So my friend here, you know, she,
Please hold, sir.
She has this deranged psychopath in her life.
No, let's ask him a nice question.
That she talks to because he's a bad boy. But he's, like, really kind of off his rocker and could really hurt her.
No, you know? Eric, that's not a good question. Do you have any relationship advice for us?
I'm not sure I'm the best.
You're not good at relationships?
Well, I've been in one for a long, long, long time.
Really? You haven't been in a relationship a long time?
I have been.
Oh, you have been?
Yeah.
You're married.
What's the secret?
Well, not exactly. Domestic partnership.
Oh, domestic partnership. Oh, you do? Okay, just be quiet for 1 second, sir. So you've been married for a long time. What keeps the relationship going?
Yeah, what spices it up?
We're very, very compatible. We like a lot of the same things. We have a lot of the same interests. We can talk a lot about.
That's great.
Yeah. So, you know, and we're nice to each other, respectful to each other.
Oh, and wow. Like, this is a good catch right here.
We like spending time together, but on the other hand, we both like, you know, to do
your separate things.
Sometimes, yeah.
Wow, you see. Your chest hair, Daddy. No, stop. Oh, I'm just getting a caller. Thank you so much, sir. Yes, caller, how can I help you?
All right. Yeah, Lisa, we were on these levels of like clarity and I'm sitting in my cardboard house drinking. Little Sparrow tweet making my balls itch.
All right. He's making.
I want you to keep me on a real serious levels, organic levels, honey.
Like, I know what you're doing right now. I know what you're doing. I know what this guy's doing. He's making fun of this guy Spartan. All right.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are. You're talking just
you're
like.
Bitch.
All right.
I'm coming for you, bitch.
All right. Okay, maybe I should just end now. Who's that, Eric? So many people are calling you right now. You think it's Elaine? Can we call him? All right.
Yeah, we could call him.
All right, so tomorrow should be good. Yes, how can I help you? Hello?
Yeah.
All right, so tomorrow should be good because we're going to Long Beach. You're gonna meet my new assistant, Judith. How would you describe Judith?
Very down to earth. Nice. Very grounded.
Yes.
People person. I think if you like me, you'll like Judith.
Yeah.
You know?
We all used to hang out. We were like three buddies in the office. We would like all hang out. We would go to lunch together and just have the best time. And Judith, do you remember that one time we were at like a Jamaican restaurant with Judith and a bunch of people. There was like 12 people and I got into a big fight with Judith and she slammed the chair down. Were you there?
I think I kind of.
Yeah. It was great. And it was like, man, I wish I was doing IRL then, because Judith is so funny, and she was so mad at me that day, and it was just the best. Yes, how can I help you?
Burn all the kikes.
All right, don't say that. We have Judy coming. We have not Elaine coming.
Elaine texted, are you okay?
Yes, call me, say. Come on, Elaine. At least shout out the stream or do something. Oh, man.
You want me to call Elaine?
Yeah, just call Elaine, and then we'll end. Yeah, call Elaine and then we'll end. But I think it's been pretty good.
I think I should ask her to go see a movie.
Yeah, with just you probably. Right? All right.
We get all three of us go see.
I would go see a movie too.
Yeah.
One movie.
Hey.
Hey. Oh my God, Elaine, yay. Oh, Andy's calling. I have Andy and Elaine. Wait, Andy's on the phone and Elaine's on the phone. Both of our hubbies are on the phone.
Oh my God.
Okay. Okay, Andy, I'm just talking to Elaine because I'm with Elaine's boyfriend right now named Eric.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we should go on a double date. Yeah. Andy, Elaine.
Yes.
Andy, say hi to Elaine.
I love it.
Andy, say hi to Elaine.
Hi, Elaine, baby.
Hi, Andy, baby.
Alisa, it's Gina. We're in the car together. We're heading back to Hollywood right now.
Oh.
Oh. You need the address.
Oh, my address? Andy's coming right now?
Yes.
Okay. Bring Andy to the park. I'm at San Vicente Park right now. Bring him there. I'm there.
We're not going to be there for an hour. We're about an hour and 40 minutes.
Okay, so I should give Andy my address? Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Or we can meet at like a cafe.
Yeah, we can meet at a cafe.
We will still be together then?
Sure.
Okay, Elaine, do you hear that? Okay, so it sounds like...
Sounds like Andy's going to be here in about an hour,
okay,
or an hour and a half.
Andy's going to be here an hour and a half, and Elaine's going to be there, and Eric's going to be there, and...
What about Fonzie?
If you're at the Santa Fe Park, you need Fonzie. I know, but we're streaming right now. It's hard... It's hard to.
Alisa.
Yes.
Can you text us? Can you text Andy the address that we should go to where we'll be in about an hour and 40 minutes?
Yes.
All right. Awesome.
Okay. Awesome. Thanks, Gene.
I can't wait to see you,
Andy. Okay. So you're staying with me for a couple days.
poor little baby. I can't wait. I'm going to hug you so hard. Kiss you.
Oh, my God. Okay.
It sounds like he's got feelings for you.
I guess he does. Yeah.
Wait.
Andy. What? Andy, are you okay with going to the coin collection thing that I told you about tomorrow?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? You want to collect coins?
Yeah, I do collect coins. I've been collecting them, you know.
All right.
My whole life.
Okay, all right. So Andy's coming to the coin collection thing. I mean, we could make it a double date. I just have to convince my friend Elaine that of a couple things.
Yeah, because she wants to stream the whole thing.
So Elaine, okay, Andy, I'll see you. I'm going to text you my address, okay?
Okay, baby, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, all right, see you soon. Okay, so Andy's coming. All right, Elaine, so there's no way that you could be with us? There's no way, Elaine? Even if I didn't put the camera on you, I'd just put on myself?
I don't know. Let me just think about this. I mean, I would meet with you guys, but off live stream would be fun.
All right. Okay, we could do that right now. You want to do that right now, Elaine?
Well, aren't you live streaming?
I'll end it to hang out with you. I'll end it to hang out with you, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds good.
All right, we'll come towards you right now.
Well, actually, I'm right down the street on
7K. All right, I'll end my stream. I'm ending it. You could even verify that, okay? No, we're not meeting anyone.
Yeah, there's like nobody here. It's totally
we're not. Elaine, seriously, I'm so happy I got to stream with Eric today. I wish I was doing it with you. We had the best time doing this together.
All your fans
and
spoke
your fans
up.
Like love you, freaking love you.
They love
we met Jim Carrey and we had the best time.
And Elisa has a new song, and she sang her new song.
I sang a new song, and we were dancing, and Elaine, that could be us! That could be us, Elaine!
I don't want to be doing live streaming. I will dance with you until the clouds come home.
All right, so you do not want to live stream ever again? You don't want to?
I really don't want to. I really, really, really don't.
Okay. All right.
I'm sorry.
All right, we'll meet you now. We'll meet you now. I won't bring it up again. All right, I won't bring it up again. Come meet us now. All right, I'll see you in a second. Okay, all right.
Where are you exactly?
San Vicente Park. It's very nice here, by the library.
Yeah, well, okay, so where exactly are you?
By the little, like, kids area here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to be under a tree, because I'll put my stream away. All right, guys, you win some, you lose some, all right? In life, you know, some things work out, some things don't. I will be meeting with Elaine. I'm going to turn off my stream. I want to thank everybody for tuning in today.
Thank you so much.
Eric, you know, has been such a delight. I just love him. And I know everybody loves him. If you want to follow Eric, how do they do that? How do they follow you?
They can just go on Facebook and look up
Eric Riggs. Look up Eric Riggs on all social media. He is an amazing musician. He writes songs. He wrote me a couple songs. He wrote a book. So Eric wrote a book that's on Amazon, The Guild to Marrying Elisa A. Schwartz. That's me. You don't know my real last name.
It was supposed to be Guide, but it was...
Oh, yeah. It was supposed to be Guide, but it was a typo. So please buy the book, The Guide or The Guild to Marrying Elisa A. Schwartz, if you want to learn how to propose to me. And thank you all so much for joining. And for supporting me and Eric.
If you're wondering how to propose to her, you get down on one knee and you just go, You go, Elaine, sweetheart, will you marry me?
And she says yes, and then I'll never get to stream with anyone again. All right, bye everyone.